A trip to the Empire Division Finals is on the line. This is it. Sunday afternoon hockey in Fraser, Michigan. The number two Motor City Rockers and your number three Danbury Hattricks in game three of a best of three series. And it's live right here on the Hattricks Digital Network. Hello again, Hattricks fans. End of the weekend. Do or die time. Doug Latuca alongside Patrick Furnett. And Pat, we've been in Michigan now for a couple of days. Hattricks stumbled in game one on home ice. Came back yesterday, played more of their style. Less run and gun, structured defensively. And the Hattricks get two goals from a rookie in Colby Johnson, including the game winner. And the cherry on top from Johnny Ruiz is shorty to put the game out of reach.
Absolutely, and that play was quite a treat to see. I mean, he batted that puck down like he knew it was just there, like he used the force for him to get that puck and just go right to Babin and shoot while he wasn't looking. And, you know, I was talking with Steve Brown last night after the game, and one of the things that really popped out to me in the conversation mentioned that Johnny has really good puck luck. And I would have to agree. I believe there's skill there, obviously, with Ruiz. But, again, with just that play in particular, that's definitely where the puck luck could apply.
Now, game one, a lot different than game two in terms of volume of shots. Now, game one, we saw over 110 shots combined. Yesterday, we had 66. 36 shots on McCollum, 30 on Babin. McCollum was outstanding in the limited action that he saw. A lot of shots from the outer edge, not much in tight. And the Hattricks solving the puzzle a little bit of Babin. Up under the bar a couple of goals.
Yeah.
Not many goalies are going to stop the shots we saw from Johnson and McKittrick last night.
No, not at all. And again, like I mentioned yesterday, Babin is a pretty top caliber goalie in this league, and they're bound to have some sort of weakness there. And again, it seems to be that blocker side, or for most goalies, going bar down or top shelf seems to be the way to get past Babin.
So these teams felt each other out at the beginning of the series. Now it's the third game in 3 days. They know each other's styles. They know the tendencies. They know the players to watch out for. It's just putting the pieces together for this Hattricks squad coming away with a victory. Now, either way, Danbury heads back to Connecticut tonight.
Correct.
Either will be a deflated group or an elated group.
Yes.
Pat, how do the Hattricks come away with a victory and advance to round two in a matchup with first place Binghamton?
Well, again, they got to use their knowledge of being in game three scenarios. Again, Motor City being only in their second season of being a team, they've never been in a game three scenario, swept by Columbus last year, going the full route here with us. So Danbury knows how to elevate a situation like that, kind of navigate around it, and again, play solid defense and get a few opportunities against Babin.
It was another tight game yesterday. Hattricks got out to a 3-1 lead about 4 minutes into the third period. 2 minutes later, Motor City tightened it up again, made it 3-2 on a point shot deflected in. But Johnny Ruiz shorthanded read a pass up top and beat Babin on the glove side for Danbury's fourth goal en route to the 4-2 game two victory. Well, folks, it is time for the anthem here at Big Boy Arena in Fraser, Michigan.
Was so happy.
Of the opening round Empire Division semifinals. The winner heads to round two with a date with the Binghamton Black Bears, who swept the Watertown Wolves in their opening round series, got the job done last night. Motor City in the purple tops, black bottoms, and purple socks with white and black striping. Hattricks in the familiar orange on top and the socks, black pants, and the white and black stripes. Pat, what do the Hattricks have to do in the first 5 minutes to come away to get off to a good start?
Like I said beforehand, just playing that good defense, and honestly, really got to get a feel, because again, these guys both slept in their own beds last night, got a decent amount of rest, not sleeping on a sleeper bus or a coach bus. So again, they might be in a new rhythm.
Hattricks starting the newly formed third line, Chase Harwell, Colby Johnson, and Nick DiNicola, with Xavier Abdella and Kyle Gonzalez on defense. Connor McCollum with his third consecutive start in this series, and his fourth start in the last five. Nick DiNicola reinserted into the lineup last night, paid off, had an assist. Colby Johnson, big number 81, two goals yesterday, his first two playoff points, and the game winner in the third period in the victory last night. TJ Sneap feathers it inside for Pavel Svitznov, near sideboards, throws it towards the middle, off the backside of Kyle Gonzalez, who headbands Chase Harwell. Steps inside the line, wrist shot, fought off by Babbitt. He didn't see it, at least where the rebound went. And it ricocheted to the near side corner. Whacked around at center. And Tristan Wells kisses it off the glass into the Hattrick zone. A minute gone by, first period in game three of this first round series. Here's Miguel Diaz dangling through. Ratcliffe banks it off the boards. Johnny Ruiz scored a shorthanded goal last night. His backhander goes up into the netting.
And that was a pretty good first possession from Dan Mary. I'd have to argue, again, they're getting that feel right now, and they're trying to figure out this Motor City defense as of right now. However, I feel that it's going to only progress as the night goes on. And these two are just going to play one of the strongest games of hockey we've seen all year.
Face off at the far circle. They wrestle for it. It springs to the far corner and all the way around. Scott Koash has been quiet in this series. The Rockers' leading goal scorer and point producer in the regular season. It's Miguel Diaz flinging it up the far side. Giuliano along the kick plate. McCollum out of the net. Rings it up and out of play, and it's a delay of game on McCollum. Rockers are headed to the power play, the number three ranked power play in the FPHL during the regular campaign. Gets a crack at it, not even 2 minutes in to the first period. Rockers 1-for-3 on the man advantage in this series. They scored a power play goal last night. Hattricks 0-for-9 in the series on the power play. Rockers can open the scoring here. Danny Vanderweel near side. Delaney rips one wide. Kept at the right point by Milam. Below the goal line, it's in the skate. Steve Brown comes over, lost it. Milam pass. Delaney shoots it wide. He pulled it. Rockers keep it alive with a minute 30 on the power play. Vanderweel crisscrossing with Milam up near the blue line. darts to the goal, now around. The lefty on his forehand, looking. Up top, Miguel Diaz touches Delaney, return Miguel Diaz. Winds, moves left, wrist shot blocked by a kneeling Berry. Juggling puck, Miguel Diaz settles with 1:10 on the power play clock. Berry swats it down and forces it into the rocker zone. Ruiz, right off the bench, had a shorty last night. Up the right wing, throws one towards the middle, springs off the far boards, and Vanderweel gets it to King, who rims it around. Lane King, a name to look out for, goal and three assists in the first two games. Josh Colton and TJ Sneath with 4 points each for the Rockers. Daniel McKittrick and Johnny Ruiz on for the hat-tricks. The two leading point producers for the hat-tricks in this series. McCollum survives a dangerous play. His clear hit off the backside of a rocker and then plopped right down, and he gets a stoppage. So still 30 seconds left on the Rockers' power play. Bedard off the faceoff, failed to clear, keep at the right point. King, left side, throws it into the middle, they score! Cross-slot pass, an easy finish, and the Rockers start the scoring with about 3 minutes into the first period. Well, Pat, we thought we would hear from Scott Koash eventually. He gets his first goal of the series in the first couple minutes of game three.
Again, he's been a quiet figure on this Motor City team, and like you said, it's been kind of waiting for when it was going to happen, and unfortunately it happens here.
So a 1-0 Rockers lead in game three, do or die for both of these teams. Jared Yao reinserted into the lineup yesterday, dealing with an injury, but was paired with Steve Brown last night. Same thing true today. Harwell dancing at the blue line. It's suckered out to the neutral zone, and Svitznov tried to sauce on the backhand for Colton. It was bunted down by Yao and tossed back in to the rocker zone. Lofted into the hat-tricks territory, just wide of McCollum, and a whistle and an icing on Motor City. So the opening goal, Scott Koash on the power play from Lane King and Josh Colton. So 5 points now for King and Colton in this series. Three assists and two goals for both of them. Ozone faceoff, hat-tricks control, pass to the back, ramped down to center, and Xavier Abdella reorganizes. Dita Di Gonzalez onto the tape of Woolley. Dishes near side, Berry. Play is onside. Berry centers for Woolley off of his stick. Puck pops in the air, and the Rockers' goal scorer, Koash, shovels it out to center ice. So Motor City now 2-for-4 on the power play in the series. One of their goals coming last night on the PP, and tonight, 3:22 into the first period, they have a 1-0 lead. Johnny Ruiz winds, fires high off the back glass, and it's launched out to center ice, where LaBelle touches it for Bedard. McKittrick throwing it ahead, Cunningham settles on the backhand, shoots, snagged with the glove by Bevin, and the whistle. We've played 5:07, period one, Motor City in front, 1-0 on a Scott Koash power play goal. You're watching Playoff Hockey on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
Stop by TK's American Cafe on White Street in Danbury and try one of their 76 amazing wing flavors. Visit TK'sAmericanCafe.com for more information.
Danbury Parking Authority. Park in the Patriot Garage across the street from the Danbury Ice Arena. It's safe, secure, and legal. Make sure the only ticket you get is to the game.
Danbury Chiropractic and Wellness. Dr. Jared DiLorenzo is a proud member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Stop by and see them on North Street in downtown Danbury. Feeling good is an option, and they can get you there.
Buzz 8 Appliance Scratch and Dent Outlet is the local leader for appliances and household wares. Do you like to eat? They have a refrigerator. Do you want clean clothes? They have a washer. They got it all. It's Buzz 8 Appliance. Coca-Cola is the official beverage of the Danbury Hattricks. Sweet, fizzy goodness. As refreshing as you remember.
Doug Latuca, Patrick Frenette, Game 3 inside Big Boy Arena in Fraser, Michigan. Rockers holding a 1-0 lead on a power play goal from Scott Koash at 3:22, officially introducing him to this series. The leading goal and point producer during the regular campaign for the Rockers. He was held off pretty quiet in the first two games. Conway nearly got behind LaBelle, but the 6'6 D-man recovered well. Tosses it across for Bedard, who tripped over the puck. Gets back to his skates. Sneath dangling through. Pursues the puck in the near corner. Throws in front. Picked off by Bedard, who takes a whack to the gloves. Gave up possession at center. And Vanderweel, quick up for King. He'll dump it in. McCollum jabs at it. It's punched out to center by Cunningham. Cunningham tied up near side. Bedard flings one towards goal. Waffled aside by Babin. Cunningham in front. Yao shoots. No, he didn't shoot. He held on. He goes around the net. Put it towards the middle. And it never got there. It was blocked. He faked the shot. Johnson and Harwell digging for the puck behind the net. Two for the Hattricks, three for the Rockers. A log jam. Babin calling for the whistle. Puck is not moving. There's a lot of shoving going on. And there goes Johnson and Harwell. And now we've got a scrum in the near corner. Johnson and Harwell said, "How much shoving can we take? This is ridiculous." And now Steve Brown gets involved. Looks like matching penalties. That's Smith for the Rockers and Brown for the Hattricks. Couple of gloves, helmets scattered along the ice. Playoff hockey, Pat.
Definitely, and again, tensions are high tonight, being a decisive Game 3, and these two have pretty much had enough of each other playing Friday and Saturday night back-to-back. 10-hour bus rides. I know that's been a constant theme throughout this series. However, it seems to have not really affected either team thus far.
The ice was booked all morning here at Big Boy Arena. Tournament time in Michigan. So we'll wonder how the surface will play, could affect the speed of the game. The Rockers have a head start with a 1-0 lead. 13:26, the reading on the clock. And the Rockers have been assessed a penalty. So after that scrum, Avery Smith is the only penalized player, roughing at 6:34. And now the Hattricks get their first power play of the afternoon. Rockers scored about 3.5 minutes in on a tape-to-tape cross-slot feed. Koash snapped it home from the far circle. Let's see if the Hattricks have an answer. There's a bit of confusion near the scorer's area. Smith is in there, so is Declan Conway. So if I had to guess, maybe an abusive official. They have Brown as well for roughing. Brown is in the box. So Brown, Smith, and Conway with roughing calls, and it works out for a Hattrick's power play. Top unit on. McKittrick, straightaway LaBelle, return for McKittrick behind him. Johnson to LaBelle. Wine shoots! Saved by Bamman, and no rebound. So Pat, early on, Johnson moved to the top unit on this power play.
And I
big
feel,
body in front,
yeah,
and I, skilled as well.
I'd have to agree. I feel pretty good about that, especially with the performance that he's been putting on in this latter half of the season. And again, with last night grabbing two goals, including the game winner, definitely deserves to be in that spot.
It's just his seventh game with the Hattricks, played five in the regular season. Put up 5 points in the regular campaign. His two goals tied for the most in this series. McKittrick darts through center, gains the line, hits the brakes for Zach Pamelaan, returning from a two-game suspension, quarterback of the second unit. Pamelaan surveys, switches spots with Ruiz, lost the puck, chopped out to center. King off to the races, Harwell getting back. King closed off by Harwell. Rockers wanted a penalty, they do not get it. And Pamelaan tripped down at center, gets back to his feet. 50 seconds on the power play. Berry floats it in to the right of Babin, gets his stick on it, and the Rockers clear. So, officially, the penalties were Smith and Brown for roughing, and then Babin got a penalty, which is served by Conway for the goalie leaving the crease. So, we mentioned Babin had 65 more penalty minutes than any other goalie in the league during the regular season. Penalized here as the Hattricks on the power play for the next 15 seconds. Delaney, shorthanded breakaway, one-on-one! Blocker saved by McCollum! In a full split, he robs Delaney again on a breakaway. Here's a shot, they score! Wynn roofs it on the backhand. Shorthanded goal, and the Rockers go up 2-0. So McCollum with a highlight reel stop. Hattricks can't possess the puck, do not get it out, and Wynn with a beauty, bar down over the shoulder of McCollum, and the Rockers doing what the Hattricks did today.
Essentially, Doug, and it definitely feels like a different Rockers team, especially they're getting off to this hot start, already scoring once in the power play and now on the shorthand. It's definitely going to be interesting to see how the rest of this game goes.
So not an ideal start for the Hattricks, who trail 2-0 with 11:30 remaining in the first period, and the Rockers are flying. Play is offsides, late whistle, as Abdella collided with Conway. So Koash and Wynn with the goals. Mike Wynn shorthanded from TJ Delaney at 8:28. Power play and shorthanded goal for the Rockers early on. It was Ruiz who scored the shorthanded goal last night for Danbury, the insurance tally, and Delaney extends the Motor City lead to 2-0. Now, we remember the Hattricks in game one got out to a 2-0 lead. They led 3-1 yesterday. Of course, Motor City scored the next three goals in that first game and came all the way back, won it in overtime. Hattricks will have to come from behind here. Cunningham has space, shoots! Deflected up into the netting. And the face-off at the near circle after the Hattricks make some changes. Now, Pat spoke with some of the players before the game. They felt extremely confident about tonight. Due to their experience, they know what it's like in a win-or-go-home environment. And you'd have to anticipate that Billy McCreary has this team calm, cool, and collected, even though they're in a two-goal hole.
Absolutely, Doug. And again, Billy is all about perseverance and keeping a straight face, keeping that poker face going, because again, we've seen this team take some nonsensical penalties that really kind of took them out of games.
Now, Motor City, it was a storyline coming in. Had the second best PK, third best power play in the regular season. Yao, up the gut, shoots! Airmailed it, and it plops down off the back glass. Rockers 2-for-4 on the power play in this series. They've held the hat tricks scoreless on the man advantage and have buried one on the kill today. Scrum fort behind the net. Gulo tied up with Berry out to the point. Milam can't keep, and it trickles down into Motor City territory. Hat-tricks making changes. Babin fanned on the outlet pass. Ramped in at the red line. Pamelaian swaps it out to Delaney. Goes cross ice. And Giuliano plays back for Miguel Diaz. Midway point, first period. Rockers with a power play and shorthanded goal to take a 2-0 lead in game 3 of the opening round series. Timeout on the ice, 2-0 Rockers. You're watching Danbury Hat-Tricks Playoff Hockey on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
Coltech, the founder of Plastic Chamber Technology, is headquartered locally in Brookfield. Coltech is family-owned and operated with experience in the drainage industry dating back to the 1950s. When you're talking drainage and stormwater, Coltech is the world leader. Contact them today at coltech.com.
Fairfield County Bank is the official bank of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. It's where the Hat-Tricks bank and the tellers wear the Danbury Hat-Tricks top hat. Fairfield County Bank is your hometown bank and a proud supporter of your hometown team.
For a comfortable stay with great amenities, the only choice is the La Quinta by Wyndham in Danbury. Ask for the Hat-Tricks friends and family rate. You can't beat it. La Quinta.
Texas Roadhouse, located on Newtown Road in Danbury, opened its doors locally in 2017 and is known for hand-cut steaks, cactus blossom, fall-off-the-bone ribs, made-from-scratch sides, and fresh-baked bread. The restaurant prides itself on its legendary food, legendary service, and legendary fun.
Halfway point, first period, Rockers 2, Hat-Tricks nothing. In a must-win game 3, the winner advances to the second round to play the Binghamton Black Bears on home ice. Game 1 either here at Big Boy Arena or at the Danbury Ice Arena on Friday night. Tuck Latuka, Patrick Furnett is to my left. And Pat, the Hat-Tricks, a rough patch in the first 10 minutes. What do they have to do to get back to their game, similar to what we saw yesterday?
Well, really, Doug, it's all about winning the rest of this period, not letting anything go through McCollum, trying to not put McCollum in a situation where he really has to be on his head.
Didn't have much of a chance on either of the goals. One, a snapper tap-in on the power play, and the second one, shorthanded. Hat-Tricks kept it in at the line. It was Di Nicola. Couldn't settle that bouncing puck as it skitters all the way below the goal line. McCollum rims it for Di Nicola. Had an assist last night. Headband for Harwell. Missed connection, and it's an icing. Now Danbury, earlier in the season, went on a run of comeback wins, mostly against the Binghamton Black Bears. They have clawed their way back into many games this season. And last year, the consensus feeling was if the Hat-Tricks went down, there was confidence that they would crawl their way back into any game, no matter what the deficit was. That playoff mindset of you're never done until the horn sounds. Hat-Tricks need that moving forward. King, right side, throws it towards the middle, wrapped off of a stick, kicks near side. Ruiz's stick flew in the air. Wynn tripped over himself. Pamelaian takes control. And across for Bedard. Pamelaian on defense with Bedard now. Abdella steps onto the ice. Vanderweel cutting in. The puck was available, and Sneath fanned on the shot. Vanderweel in the corner. To the near side. George Holt, 42, in purple. Crunched by Abdella. Delayed penalty. And a tripping call on the hat-tricks. Zachary Pamelain to the sin bin. And this lethal Rockers power play that is already converted tonight. That's their second opportunity. They can open the floodgates here, Pat.
They really could, but again, all Danbury has to do is just be simple. Send that puck down the length of the ice and kill off the rest of this kill and, again, win the rest of the period.
Ratcliffe, Berry, Yao, and Brown, the four penalty killers for the hat-tricks. Nicholas McGill-Diaz quarterbacks this Rockers power play. 15 ticks gone on the advantage. Jamison Milam rims it around. Giuliano crashes with Yao into the boards, and Berry throws it the length. Hat-tricks at 13 shorthanded goals in the regular season, tied for the second most. They scored a shorty last night. Vanderweel. Puck hopped on him. Low left, around the net, McGill-Diaz. Lost possession, got it back. Delaney, touched on for Milam, walks in. Delaney for McGill-Diaz. Everything at the perimeter. Vanderweel, far circle, back for McGill-Diaz. Shoots, deflected off of Giuliano. Delaney shielding the puck with his big frame. Right point, Milam, winds, dishes, Delaney. Straight away, McGill-Diaz. Near side, Giuliano. Back, McGill-Diaz. 35 on the power play. Delaney, wrist shot blocked by Yao. Up in the air. It's available in the low slot. Still there in the skates of Yao. And he chips it out to center. And back into the Rocker zone. 20 seconds remaining on the power play. 6:40 to go in the opening period. King around the check of Abdella. Far corner. To the right point, Colton for Koach. Power play winding down. Out of the box, Pamelain. Thrown to the middle. Ruiz ahead for Pamelain. Tried to kick it to himself. Went through his wickets. And Conway backtracks. So Pamelain now with Ratcliffe and Berry. He hops off, and Woolley takes the spot. Patrick's getting one extra player back. Puck tipped on goal, and McCollum holds it for the whistle. Danbury was playing shorthanded for the first two games of this series due to the Pamelain multi-game suspension. Now that he returns, the Patrick's going with 10 forwards, 6 defensemen, and Connor McCollum making his 5th start in the last 6 games. In his last 9 starts, Connor McCollum has a .949 save percentage. He was outstanding last night, 34 for 36 in the Game 2 win. Wrestled for in front, the shot went just wide off the stick of Tristan Wells, 57 in purple. Shots are even at 4. Run off the back of the goal. Rockers controlling the puck in the offensive zone, putting pressure on the hat-tricks. Danbury trying to counter. Berry tosses it in, gets a change. As we approach 5 minutes to go in the first, Rockers with 2 goals on the special teams, 8.5 minutes in. Power play goal, then a shorthanded goal. Rockers are offsides. And we're at the last on-ice timeout of period number 1. Rockers leading the hat-tricks 2-0 in a game that determines who advances to round 2.
Stay with us on the Hattrix Digital Network.
Diversified Printing Solutions in Danbury is the Hattrix official printing partner. You want it printed? Call Tina and let them get it inked up for you. They could do it all. Locally owned and printed on paper from Connecticut trees.
Dr. Matt Hartsburg is an official member of the Danbury Hattrix medical team. Hartsburg Chiropractic is cutting-edge chiropractic care right here in your backyard. Check out Hartsburg Chiropractic and get on the road to a pain-free hockey season. Blue Light Electric is a proud sponsor of the Danbury Hattrix. Blue Light Electric happily provides service to all parts of Connecticut, performing high-quality electrical work for residential and commercial properties. Blue Light Electric is always accepting new customers.
Litchfield Distillery. It's the spirit of hard work. The Batchers of Litchfield Distillery, in honor of the early farmers of Northwest Connecticut, present to you the locally made Litchfield Distillery bourbon, vodka, and gin. Grab a beverage at the Rabbit Hole and hoist the barrel with the Hattrix.
Final game of the opening round series, and Motor City in control. We've played about 15 minutes in period one. Rockers with goals from Koash and Wynn. Power play and shorthanded. 3:22 and 8:28. The Hattrix with just four shots on goal. Same number for the Rockers, just a bit more opportunistic. Yao sprints after a bouncing puck, swept back into the Hattrick zone, and Steve Brown leads the rush for Yao. Rainbows it near side. Icing waved off. Johnson beat McGill-Diaz. They tie up in the corner. Puck is underneath McGill-Diaz, so the whistle blows. Pat expected a bit of a bigger turnout on a Sunday afternoon in the rubber match of a playoff series. But the Hattrix fans that were here last night still repping the black and orange. Long way to travel, but I bet you they're happy they got to see not just one game, but two.
Exactly, Doug. And again, the Danbury faithful are probably some of the best fans, if not the best fans, in the FPHL. And they'll travel wherever this team goes. Binghamton, I'm sure they'll be there. And then, you know, if we make it all the way to the finals, they'll probably go wherever we go.
Puck was deflected into the netting by McCullum for the faceoff to his right. Danbury prevails, and it's Josh LaBelle parked behind the Hattrick's cage. Bedard for McKittrick. Tips it into the far corner. Milam and Cunningham in a race. Lumberjacked up the far boards. Wobbling at center, it's Giuliano, skates into it. Crisscrosses, Koash receives, shoots, chest save. Rebound batted wide by Giuliano. Another sharp angle shot off the outside of the cage. Rockers applying pressure, thought maybe they would be the more nervous squad. First time Motor City is in a game three. They got swept by Columbus last year in round one. And so far, the Rockers look comfortable, and they've relied heavily on the special teams, which is partially what got them the number two seed in the regular season. 7 points better than the Hattrix in the standings, as Abdella blindly was trying to locate Gonzalez. Pass went awry. Vanderwill keeps it at the left point, climbs the wall, surveying around the net. Shot stop at the pad. Goulot wins the battle. Right point shot tipped wide. Goulot return for Vanderwill. It's in the low slot, and Abdella settles things. Both teams making partial changes. As we're under three to go in the first. Conway getting a glove full from McCullum. Johnson taps it, chases. Him and Vanderwiel engage. They battle two aside behind Babin. Johnson finds Harwell to the near point, whose pass was blocked. The outlet, it's Sneef. Off the skate of King. Puck wobbling on Brown. But he corrals. And then the outlet into the skates of Harwell. Giuliano shoots. Glove save McCollum. And he holds on. Hattricks have not gotten into an offensive flow quite yet, Pat. Rockers doing pretty much anything they want. And Danbury has yet to find its legs in the first 18 minutes of this period. And as the Hattricks are making changes, the Rockers barking. McGill, Diaz, and Harwell separated. Face off at the right circle, Hattrick zone. Ruiz and Giuliano for the draw. Vanderweel is still on the ice at center, talking with the referee. Not sure why. Vanderweel, the captain. So he is the main point of contact with the officials. So he's sent to the bench and the faceoff. Shoveled out by Bedard. McGill, Diaz, harassed by McKittrick. Cunningham shoots. Glove save, Babbitt. Corey Cunningham, the Hattricks Rookie of the Year, second on the team in goals with 23 in the regular season. No goals in the first two games. Does have two assists. 5 points in his last four games. The 22-year-old from Prince George, British Columbia. Ruiz and Sneef for the far circle draw. .142 left, first period. 2-0 Rockers. Two goals in the first 8.5 minutes. One on the power play, one shorthanded. Winner of this game plays Binghamton next Friday night in round two opener. Left pad save from McCollum. Charlie Bedard finds a lane. Headbands Cunningham, joins the play. Cunningham gets the red, dumps it in. McGill, Diaz connects with Conway. Cross ice, tipped and gloved by Ratcliffe at the red line. Pestered by King. And Abdella across for Bedard. With a minute remaining in the first period, Hattricks ice it.
Now, Doug, to say the least, I do feel they've been battling out the rest of this period, not letting anything get through, really just trying to play a simple game, get the puck on the other side of the length whenever they're on the penalty kill, and again, keep it simple for this last minute, and imagine the locker room talk will be intense.
The Rockers look a little quicker, a little more desperate in this first period than the Hattricks, and the scoreboard reflecting that. Shots are just 7-5, so kind of on theme from yesterday's game. But for the Rockers, at least tonight, the quality of opportunities much greater than what we saw yesterday. A scramble in the corner to the back. Milam shoots, stick save, rebound, Koash! Filters it into the breadbasket of McCollum, who gets the cover. And now things continue to intensify. Chippiness more apparent tonight than in the previous two games, as Abdella has a jersey full of Delaney. And coincidental liners. Delaney and Abdella. Or maybe not. Oh yes, they have sent Abdella off the ice, which makes sense considering we are under 2 minutes to the break. So should just be two roughing calls. So we play 4-on-4. Delaney and Abdella, the guilty party. D-zone draw. A tie-up. Yao comes away with it. Sprints up the gut. Steps over the blue line. Has Harwell charging. Finds him. Fan on the shot. Throws it inside. Gonzalez shoots. Deflected off the back glass. Spits to the near side. Johnson touching for Gonzalez. Gets it back. They wrestle for it in the corner. Slid down low for Harwell. Point shot. Snagged by Babin with not much trouble nor traffic in front. And an offensive zone faceoff coming for the Hatricks with 11.2, the reading on the clock, first period. Faceoff at the near circle, Giuliano and Ruiz. The Rockers veteran wins it. And then controls in the near corner. Throws one to neutral ice. Off the boards, Ruiz plays. And the first period comes to an end. All Rockers in the first 20 minutes. Goals from Koash and Wynn at 3:22 and 8:28. Have Motor City up by two. Koash on the power play, Wynn shorthanded. Not many offensive opportunities for either team. Rockers doing their damage in the first 8.5 minutes. 9-6 the shots after one period of play. Hatricks looked a little bit uncomfortable in that first period, Pat. Sluggish, slow, not crisp on passes to the neutral zone. Not winning many board battles for possession. Rockers seem quicker, more on it. Winning those battles, getting more shots. At least more time in the offensive zone. And they capitalize on the man advantage. Steal the puck from the Hatricks on the kill. Roof one. And Danbury staring at a two-goal hole.
I mean, currently, Doug, I never want to say what I think is going through the players' heads or what I want to believe. But I think it's just a little bit of overconfidence, right? So you're thinking, you know, you're going into this game three. You think you got it. And again, that kind of shows in your play that, you know, you think you got it. But again, you have the Rockers who have surprised us this first period, taking this two-goal lead. And again, leading to lapses in, like you said, neutral tape-to-tape passing, board battles getting lost. I mean, I imagine they're going to have to rebuild that kind of confidence in the second period of play and really just kind of play simple hockey again. I always utter that term, but I feel it's the best way to keep things neutral in the playoff setting such as now.
I think it's interesting that you bring up maybe overconfidence or coming in here thinking that this is a spot that the Hatricks have been in before. They were in it last year. Plenty of players remember the feeling of that postseason run, backs up against the wall. What are you going to do? Hatricks did something remarkable last year that most teams probably couldn't do. That's win three straight games. Yes, all at home, yes. But facing elimination in all three, Hatricks overcame and won their first Commissioner's Cup. But tonight, that feeling of they thought they outplayed Motor City last night handily, came away with a 4-2 win. These teams, two of the more evenly matched squads all year long, it showed through in the first two games, and Motor City probably with its best period of this series.
Absolutely, Doug. And again, Motor City can be a scary team sometimes. Granted, I know their schedule might not reflect that in our case, having a mid-division switch. However, the schedule remained the same. So they grabbed some wins against teams like Withville, which we only played twice, swept them in the regular season series. And teams also like the Mississippi Seawolves, well.
So the Hatricks trailing 2-0 after the first period. Game 3, Empire Division semifinals. The winner hosts Binghamton on Friday night in the first game of that best of 3 Empire Finals series. Binghamton taking care of Watertown after a bit of a scare in Game 1, down 2-0 after 1. Well, they erased any doubt with two quick goals in the first 4 minutes, so that second period, and then checked off win one and dominated for win number two. So, assuming plenty of Black Bears fans and maybe some players tuning in tonight just to see what they will be up against in the second round. And if it is the Hattricks and Black Bears, in 18 times you've seen each other, not many surprises. So we will definitely see what comes of that second round. But the Hattricks with some work to do if they want to get to weekend number two. And you just know that if they cannot overcome this two-goal deficit, it's going to be a long offseason for a lot of these players, for the fans. Nobody wants their summer to start this early.
Correct.
It's still April, Pat. Come on. The sun doesn't come out until June 21st.
That is correct. And
summer solstice.
Yes, yes. And I know one thing that I've heard Billy preach here on through last year's series, he hates losing. Everybody hates losing, but Billy has a certain way of hating losing that really he can just put that message into his team and they just get it. So hopefully we can really snap back to what they were like last night for period two and three. However, again, you don't want to come out gunslinging. Obviously, you do want to get some nice opportunities on that. However, keep the solid defense going and really just take the shots that you know will go. Try and get Babin on his bad side and play some Hattricks hockey.
You see Johnny Ruiz entering back on the bench. No helmet on, no stick, no gloves, just sitting and waiting for the second period to start. You know how much this means to Ruiz, turned 30 earlier this season, 29B as he likes to call it, the birth of his first child as well earlier this season. One of his best seasons in his professional career. Third year with the Hattricks, third team MVP, third offensive player of the year trophy. He's the guy who gets the motor going on this Hattricks team. Did it last night, sealed the deal shorthanded. They'll need their captain to maybe get this first goal and get the wheels rolling.
Absolutely, again. And Johnny's one that he's always felt that he's been in a leadership role since he was young. He's kind of born into that sort of mentality. And I've seen it through and through since 2021 of him just leading these guys out to a charge, really taking losses, you know, in stride and taking deficits like this in stride as well, and hopefully using that kind of negative energy, turning it into something positive, coming back and having a dominant second period would be the ideal set for Ruiz and the rest of the Hattricks.
Now, a quiet first period offensively for the Hattricks. Not much going on around Babin, who spoke to some of the Rockers personnel, said he was a bit off last night, not his best. We saw his best in game one.
Yes.
Last night, a couple bar down goals, not really much he could do, but some say he wants that Ruiz goal back on the backhand semi-breakaway. But Babin not really tested much. What do the Hattricks have to do differently in period two offensively to get more volume, more pressure, more something on Babin?
Like you said, board battles are huge. They need to start winning more of those, start being more careful with their tape-to-tape passing. Again, I really feel it was kind of a sloppy period from us. Pucks just kind of going wherever they felt like going, and it didn't really seem like we're all connected as one to really get those tape-to-tape passes going. Board battles getting won, but again, if we just keep staying in that Rockers zone, really just getting all kinds of shots on Babin, I think we could tire him out and maybe slip a few past him.
20 minutes erased. Rockers 2, Hattricks nothing. The winner advances. The loser's season comes to an end. About 10 and a half minutes until we press play on period 2. We'll take a break. You're watching Danbury Hattricks playoff hockey on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Stop by TK's American Cafe on White Street in Danbury and try one of their 76 amazing wing flavors. Visit tksamericancafe.com for more information.
Danbury Parking Authority. Park in the Patriot Garage across the street from the Danbury Ice Arena. It's safe, secure, and legal. Make sure the only ticket you get is to the game.
Danbury Chiropractic and Wellness. Dr. Jared DiLorenzo is a proud member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Stop by and see them on North Street in downtown Danbury. Feeling good is an option, and they can get you there.
BuzzAid Appliance Scratch and Dent Outlet is the local leader for appliances and household wares. Do you like to eat? They have a refrigerator. Do you want clean clothes? They have a washer. They got it all. It's BuzzAid Appliance. Coca-Cola is the official beverage of the Danbury Hattricks. Sweet, fizzy goodness. As refreshing as you remember. Coltech, the founder of Plastic Chamber Technology, is headquartered locally in Brookfield. Coltech is family-owned and operated with experience in the drainage industry dating back to the 1950s. When you're talking drainage and stormwater, Coltech is the world leader. Contact them today at coltech.com.
Fairfield County Bank is the official bank of the Danbury Hattricks. It's where the Hattricks bank and the tellers wear the Danbury Hattricks top hat. Fairfield County Bank is your hometown bank and a proud supporter of your hometown team.
For a comfortable stay with great amenities, the only choice is the La Quinta by Wyndham in Danbury. Ask for the Hattricks friends and family rate. You can't beat it. La Quinta.
Texas Roadhouse, located on Newtown Road in Danbury, opened its doors locally in 2017 and is known for hand-cut steaks, cactus blossom, fall-off-the-bone ribs, made-from-scratch sides, and fresh-baked bread. The restaurant prides itself on its legendary food, legendary service, and legendary fun.
Diversified Printing Solutions in Danbury is the Hattricks' official printing partner. You want it printed? Call Tina and let them get it inked up for you. They could do it all. Locally owned and printed on paper from Connecticut trees.
Dr. Matt Hartsburg is an official member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Hartsburg Chiropractic is cutting-edge chiropractic care right here in your backyard. Check out Hartsburg Chiropractic and get on the road to a pain-free hockey season. Blue Light Electric is a proud sponsor of the Danbury Hattricks. Blue Light Electric happily provides service to all parts of Connecticut, performing high-quality electrical work for residential and commercial properties. Blue Light Electric is always accepting new customers.
Litchfield Distillery. It's the spirit of hard work. The Batchers of Litchfield Distillery, in honor of the early farmers of Northwest Connecticut, present to you the locally made Litchfield Distillery bourbon, vodka, and gin. Grab a beverage at the Rabbit Hole and hoist the barrel with the Hattricks.
I'm Zach.
I'm Jared. We're at the Rivery Brewery right now, helping them pack up some cans.
Yep, trying this beautiful specialty New England IPA that you can get.
Hey, Zach, throw me a beer.
You got it, buddy.
Oh. I gotta catch those. I gotta work on my hands.
This guy.
Clancy Moving and Relocation. Moving is stressful, but it doesn't have to be. Call Clancy and let them do the heavy lifting for you. Resident and commercial services plus other services such as storage. Remember, Clancy is fancy.
Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury is the premier automobile partner in the Danbury area. Located on Newtown Road, the Bennett family has been putting the community behind the wheel for over 35 years. Dream big, drive a Maserati or Alfa Romeo. New and pre-owned vehicles available. Let Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury be your choice.
Dowler Garage in New Preston specializes in batteries, brakes, and general service. When you're stuck, you're in luck. Call Mike so you don't need a bike. Dowler Garage.
Peach Wave of Bethel. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your place to go for a quality treat. Frozen yogurt and toppings, it doesn't get much better. Catch a wave, a peach one.
Back inside Big Boy Arena in Fraser, Michigan, Rockers with a 2-0 lead over the Hattricks in the deciding game of the opening round. Hello again, Hattricks fans. Doug Latuca with Patrick Furnett on my left and running the camera. One of the more difficult periods we saw offensively from the Hattricks. One of the better periods that the Rockers have put together in this postseason, and the scoreboard reflects that.
And again, Doug, I'm excited to see what the second period brings. As you know, being around Ben McCreary for a few years now myself, I know that he hates losing in a way that no other coach does. And I know he'll put that message into his players, and his players will just get it. I'm hoping they click for the second period and really get some good offensive opportunities and play good defense to keep a Pullum down another score.
Well, either way, we're saying hi to Pete tonight. We're stepping on the bus. And we're driving 10 and a half, 11, 11 and a half, whatever it is, hours back to Danbury, Connecticut tonight. So emotions will either be good, they will be bad, they will be happy, they will be sad. Hattricks hoping for the positive emotions to come through. And they need to do a little bit of work to make that happen. They're going to have to come from behind. First two games of this series, Danbury got out to the lead. A 2-0 advantage in game one. They led 3-1 yesterday. Now they're in a two-goal hole. As we press play on period two, teams flip sides. Hattricks moving right to left in the orange jerseys. Motor City in the purple. They wore black last night. Hattricks in the orange for the second consecutive game. It's 4-on-4 hockey. Delaney and Abdellah are still in the penalty box for roughing. So ice opens up. Colton and Wynn, the defenseman for the Rockers. McKittrick pestering them. Ruiz, the forward with McKittrick. And there goes Wynn. Couldn't catch up to the gliding puck. And Ruiz snaps one on goal. And Babin gloves it down and hands off. 45 seconds erased. Second period. Shots after one were 9-6 Rockers. Johnson tape to tape with Harwell. Outnumbered in the offensive zone. Wrist shot blocked. Koash, who scored the opening goal on the power play tonight, gets it ahead, and it's swatted in by Svitznov, who's been quiet in this series. Had 5 assists in early December, the only 2 games of the regular season between these teams. Koash had 2 goals as well, including the game winner on the 1st of December in overtime. Milam to the back. McGill Diaz, slap shot, deflected wide. Both players out of the box. They both join the play. Delaney looking for a pass from Svitznov, steals it away, then gets shoved down by Johnson into the end boards. Two big men colliding, Pat, and Johnson gets the better of Delaney. We played 145, period two. No shots quite yet. Ratcliffe chips and charges with his teammates making changes. The line now, Cunningham, Ratcliffe, and Berry. Bit of a change up from the first period. Miguel Diaz, cross ice Giuliano. Sauced ahead through Gulo, sent back to neutral ice, and trickles onto the blade of Milam. A stick lifted, puck all the way down, and Jared Yao retrieves. 2.5 minutes in, second period. Ratcliffe steps inside the blue line, flutters one, steered aside by Babin. Vanderweel spins off a Cunningham check, emerges from behind the net, feeds it far side, nearly turned over, then Cunningham gloves down and goes. Cunningham left side, shoots, save Babin, rebound, he's got it underneath him with McKittrick whacking away. Daniel McKittrick, who scored two goals in the first two games, had a glorious opportunity on the rebound. It plopped right down in front of Babin. McKittrick tried to stuff Fifehall, but the veteran netminder keeps the hat tricks off the board.
I'm really actually happy with what I've seen in these first about, say, 2.5 minutes here in Big Boy Arena. Definitely applying a little more pressure and getting a few chips into the Rocker zone.
Off the faceoff, Vanderweel rims it around, picked off Ruiz. McKittrick slides it for Ruiz around the net. Looking for a pass, drops off Gonzalez in front, available, McKittrick shoots! It's underneath the rocker, and Ruiz keeps it the left point. Angles it for Woolley, straight away Gonzalez, wrist shot blocks by Wells, who went down on one knee. Woolley zigzagging through center, took a spill, rockers on the offense. Svitznov, left wing, wrist shot kicked out by McCollum. Svitznov back on it. Stick lifted by Abdella. Two orange jerseys in the corner, and Harwell picks it free. 3.5 off the second period clock, 2-0 hat-tricks in a hole. Harwell's wrist shot, loved by Babin, and the rebound available, but broomed out to center. Johnson gains the line. A centering feed, blocked by Colton. Bedard activates right point. Harwell around the kick plate, DiNicola near side to the net, tipped wide. Harwell in the low slot, just missed. Got a piece, but not all of it. And the puck rainbowed off the ceiling here at Big Boy Arena. So a stoppage, 4 minutes and 9 seconds in to the second.
Gotta say, again, I like that pressure that we're putting on offensively. It's really showing a nice change in momentum and just, I guess, change in mindset in between that 18 minutes there between periods.
Hat-tricks out shooting the Rockers 4-1 in the first 4 minutes of this period. Berry and Sneath for the far circle draw. Berry wins. Yao shoots. Hit his own man Woolley in front. Conway guarding the puck from Woolley. Now fending off Berry. Wheels it to King. Return to win below the goal line. He swirls in the corner, evades the check of Woolley. Hat-tricks putting on the pressure early in this game. Got to empty the tank in game three, because if you don't, you're going home. King's turnaround shot off the back glass, a turnover. And the puck touched with a high stick. Right when we're talking about the hot start in period two for the hat-tricks. Great opportunity for Motor City.
Absolutely, and again, Motor City is showing no signs of slowing down in this game. Again, I know they just spent a lot of this opening frame of this period right here being in their, you know, defensive zone. However, they still show that perseverance of getting back to the Danbury zone.
At center. Wynn throws it in.
Gonzalez touches for Abdellah, and the puck goes on goal, and McCollum gets the stoppage. 5 minutes are off the clock in the second period. 2-0 Rockers, timeout on the ice. Stay with us on the Hattrix Digital Network.
Stony Hill Dental Care has served as the leader and preferred provider of dental care in Bethel, Connecticut. Go see Dr. K. He'll make you look like $1 million and feel like it too. The official team dentist of the Danbury Hattrix.
Vision Designs is the official merchandiser of the Danbury Hattrix. Vision Designs is a full-service screen printing, embroidery, signage, and promotional company locally owned and operated in Brookfield. Vision Designs is the hometown company with the national power. Check them out at visiondesignct.com.
Decker Tool Rental is the official full-service equipment rental shop of the Danbury Hattrix, providing a complete line of quality equipment to all types of contractors, tradesmen, and do-it-yourselfers. Visit them today at 84 Federal Road in Danbury or on the web at deckertoolrental.com.
Kafala Coffee. Real coffee, good coffee, no, great coffee. Plus hot chocolate right on the concourse level at the Danbury Ice Arena. Kafala Coffee. Stay warm this winter.
Back in Michigan, Rockers possess a 2-0 lead over the Hattrix, number 2 versus number 3 in the final game of the best of 3. Winner faces Binghamton on Friday night inside either Big Boy Arena or the Danbury Ice Arena. One handed out to center by DiNicola, and the Rockers start back on the offense. Giuliano slaps it. It ramps off the back of the goal. Delaney centers into the skates of Harwell. He fends off a check. Sauces it up the near side. Turnover. Delaney behind the defense. Fan on the shot.
Wanted to lift it over the glove of McCollum, but it went off of his blade and wide. Outlet pass. Harwell just out of his reach. Turns into an icing on the Hattrix. Danbury was ready to escape and move towards Rockers territory. Puck turned over, and Delaney, who has had countless opportunities one-on-one with McCollum, the Danbury netminder outwaiting the big Rockers winger. Delaney lined up with Bedard in the near hash for this faceoff at the left circle. It's Goulot for the Rockers, Harwell for the Hattrix following the icing. Rockers win it, McGill Diaz. Across Milam. Rishot off a couple of skates, spits to the far boards. Wells, crunched by Harwell. They're tangled up, puck thrown down, rolling. Milam wins the race, or no, they just blow it dead. It's a 3-on-1 in the Hattrick zone. We mentioned Harwell and Wells were tangled. Then the puck went into the Rockers zone. And then three Hattricks coming to the aid of Harwell. Johnson and Wells exchanging chirps. Yapping between both benches. One player in the box for each side. Tristan Wells for Motor City, Chase Harwell for the Danbury Hattrix. Penalty's not official yet. I believe it is roughing on both of the players. Holding, similar, close enough. So holding penalties on Wells and Harwell, and now a meeting.
And again, Doug, I've spoke on this a few times. These are some things that are just currently just unacceptable for this group, taking these kind of penalties. I get it's a game three, very intense game three. Advancing to the Empire Final is on the line, but you got to stay a little more calm than that.
So the tea party is over. Pat, we didn't get the invitation as the refs disperse, and it's 4-on-4 hockey. Once again,
we play fours, and things open up. Miguel Diaz twirling behind the net, leads King up the far boards.
Tape to tape, Sneath, who scored last night on the winner in game one in overtime. He was rubbed off the play, rubbed off the puck by Abdellah. Patrick's move from right to left. Berry shoots wide. Rockers wanted that play blown dead for offsides, but we continue. Berry up the gut, Gonzalez. Backhand feed for Woolley, slipped inside. Berry charging, knocked away by Milam. Miguel Diaz chugs the legs up the left wing. Gets the red, gets the blue. Worked on by Abdellah, flings one wide, and it hops the stick of Wynn and out to center. Woolley calling for a change. He'll knock Miguel Diaz slightly over, heads to the bench. It is Miguel Diaz, tossing one near side, Delaney. Around Gonzalez, Abdellah staples him to the glass, and Gonzalez, backhand flutter, right onto the stick of Josh Colton for Motor City. Angled pass for Delaney. Delaney shoots, partially blocked by Abdellah, had Giuliano in front. Wall battle to a side. Wynn throws it back behind the goal line. Some clutching and grabbing. We play on. Ratcliffe, one-on-one against Colton. Ratcliffe has Harwell to his left, rather that's Ruiz. Instead it's back Pamelaan. Wrist shot blocked, pops in the air. Ratcliffe hands off Pamelaan. That's Yao down low, crashing in. Couldn't get the shot off, and he takes a tumble. Giuliano laying on top of him, and a trip. So Yao draws a penalty, tripping. Colton is the guilty party. And the hat tricks with a golden opportunity to get back within one. Patrick surrendered a shorthanded goal in the first period. That was Wynn. Extended this lead to two for the Rockers. Both goals coming via special teams. For Motor City, Koash on the PP. Wynn with the SHG. 5-on-4, faceoff at the far circle. Colton in the box for tripping. LaBelle comes away with it. Pass down low, Johnson in his skates, and it's slapped down. Wells came out of the box, as did Harwell, who joins. The hat trick's on the ice. Now it is a 5-on-4. Started off as a 4-on-3. Ruiz, right wing. Centering try, gets rubbed into the end boards. Slow to get back to his skates. And he barks at the referee. Needed a change. That slam you heard, that was Ruiz. It is Johnson. Into the middle for Woolley. Dangles in tight quarters. McKittrick to LaBelle, slap shot wide. Rebound was cleared out to center. Under a minute on the power play. 11 minutes to go in the second. No goals in this period. The hat tricks out shooting the Rockers just 4-2. A giveaway at center. King, right wing. Taken away by Berry, who leads the rush through center. Into the zone, backhand float to the middle. Detected and cleared. Motor City, strong on the kill. Patrick scoreless on the power play this series. Motor City carrying over their success in the regular season to the postseason. Brown didn't see the pass from Cunningham. Out of the zone, Svitznov beats Berry to the puck. Gains the line, throws it to the right point. Vanderweel turns and shoots, it's blocked, back to even. 10 minutes to go, second period. Cunningham, 1-on-4 into the zone. Hattrick's making changes. Hits a stanchion. Gulo sockers it down. Gallops around the net. Miguel Diaz. through center. Cunningham was huddled over, gets back to the bench. Meanwhile, Miguel Diaz backhander into the glove of McCollum. No rebound. Extracurriculars after the whistle. Timeout on the ice. Rockers, 2, hat tricks, nothing. About a little less than midway to go in this second period. We'll be back on the Hat Tricks Digital Network.
Clancy Moving and Relocation. Moving is stressful, but it doesn't have to be. Call Clancy and let them do the heavy lifting for you. Resident and commercial services plus other services such as storage. Remember, Clancy is fancy.
Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury is the premier automobile partner in the Danbury area. Located on Newtown Road, the Bennett family has been putting the community behind the wheel for over 35 years. Dream big, drive a Maserati or Alfa Romeo. New and pre-owned vehicles available. Let Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury be your choice.
Dowler Garage in New Preston specializes in batteries, brakes, and general service. When you're stuck, you're in luck. Call Mike so you don't need a bike. Dowler Garage.
Peach Wave of Bethel. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your place to go for a quality treat. Frozen yogurt and toppings, it doesn't get much better. Catch a wave, a peach one.
Doug Latuca alongside Patrick Fournette inside Big Boy Arena in Fraser, Michigan. Final game of the opening round. Rockers lead the hat tricks 2-0, two first period goals. Both coming via the special teams, power play and shorthanded. Koash and Wynn. Hat tricks a little more lively in this second period, but they have yet to beat Babin. Koash snapped one, it was deflected over the net. Johnson overskated. Harwell hammers it in. Colton to his D partner Wynn. Cross ice, Giuliano tips. McCollum settles, rims it for Woolley, who lost it to Sneath. Puck escapes the blue line. And Colton backtracks in his own zone. Collision in front of the Rockers bench. Babin flips it, far boards. Woolley starts the cycle with McKittrick. They switch spots. Rockers read it and clear. Ground off the boards for Ruiz. Ahead, McKittrick has space. McKittrick shoots. Kick save by Babin and the cover. At the last second, McKittrick had his shot partially blocked. Bit of a change of direction, and Babin stayed with it. Kicked out the left pad and keeps it 2-0 Rockers.
And again, you mentioned it earlier, this hat tricks team does look more lively in the second period. However, they just got to get more opportunities and apply more pressure, which I feel they could be doing a better job of.
Hat tricks with 5 shots in this second period. 11 overall. Rockers with just 12 of their own. Milo. Sail it out to center. Yao steps to it. Hands off Ratcliffe. Waiting, Smith went down to a knee and forces him out to center. Brown lofts it in, out of play. And another stoppage. Two of the first 4 meetings between the teams this year have gone to overtime. Rockers won both of them. 4 of the first 8 all time between the sides have gone to overtime. Each team has won twice. Hat tricks topped the Rockers in all 4 games last year. This season in the regular campaign, the team split in Danbury and
through two games in this series. They've split. Rockers winning in Danbury game one, overtime. Patrick's getting the job done last night here in Michigan, 4-2. Harwell, Johnson, and DiNicola up front. Gonzalez and Abdellah on the back. Harwell went down to a knee. Rockers won the faceoff, and Delaney scoops it up at center. Flinging it off the leg of Abdellah, and McCollum just outside the blue paint opts for the cover. You don't feel a sense of desperation from the hat tricks just yet. They have played a much better second period than the first. A little bit more jump. You have to imagine Billy McCreary was not sounding the alarms. But, especially in this elimination environment, you've got to get to your game sooner rather than later. King shot ramped off of a stick. TJ Sneath corrals in the corner. He's pressured, spits out for King, off the stick of Conway. And Ruiz up the middle for Bedard. Dances around a check, tried to go through Miguel Diaz. Lifted the stick, but the Rockers get it as far as center. LaBelle with a lane, wrists it on goal. And Babin plays it to Miguel Diaz. Long outlet, King, crunched by Brown. Gets it behind the net, through Delaney, out to center with the Rockers making changes. Vanderweel, skitters one on net, and McCollum gets another whistle.
And it's funny you mention that kind of desperation phase. Again, 6:47 left to play in this second period, followed by 20 more minutes in a third period. So really, again, no one should be very worried. I would be worried to an extent, though.
Well, it only takes one goal, Pat, to get things rolling in the right direction. As McCollum freezes play, only a couple seconds tick off the clock.
And it would be interesting to see that kind of momentum shift when and if that goal happens.
Point shot, tracked by McCollum. And two saves for Connor, who didn't have much of a chance on the two goals. One across slot, one timer on the power play, and the second one tucked under the bar, shorthanded. No goals since 8:28 of the first.
However, I will say he has kind of stiffened up a bit in net and, you know, not really let anything get past him, especially that really showed on that breakaway from earlier.
It's three games in 3 days for both of these goaltenders. Last night, McCollum outdueled Babin. Game one, it was Babin's show. Both goalies played exceptionally well in losing efforts as well. But seems like this type of a series, the goalie that makes more A-plus saves will probably come out on the winning end. As the Rockers ice the puck, face off in Motor City territory. 6:06 left in the second period. It's 2-0 Rockers. Doug Lachuca alongside Patrick Frenette. Game three, Empire Division semifinals. Winner takes on Binghamton at home on Friday night. LaBelle, right point, winds it around. Ruiz chops it to the back. Bedard had trouble with it. It's Woolley shooting. Stopped by Babin. He looked behind him. Thought it might have snuck through the arm. It did not. Motor City makes changes following the icing. So those tired players head off. And a fresh five for the team in purple. Ruiz, McKittrick, and Woolley, the top line now. LaBelle, rolling puck, snaps it down low. Ruiz, twirling below the goal line. Left point, LaBelle, looks a lane, shoots wide off the end boards. Woolley for McKittrick, shoots, it's blocked. Milam on one knee. Down low, McKittrick for Woolley at the circle. Wrister off the blocker of Babin. Milam sweeps it far side, angled off the boards for Conway, who directs it out to center. Now the Rockers dump it in. Ruiz tosses off the chest of Miguel Diaz. That's Lane King circling. Tape to tape, Smith swept away. Sneath with support, wrist shot, stop McCollum. The puck is on the far side. Cunningham darts through center, shoots, ramped off a stick, out of play. And we're at the final media timeout of the middle frame. Rockers still lead the Hattricks 2-0 in a win and advance game three. You're watching Danbury Hattricks Playoff Hockey on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Reverie Brewing Company is a featured beverage in the Danbury Ice Arena. Grab a Reverie and don't quit your daydream. When you drink Reverie, anything is possible.
Set Fitness is the official gym and training center of the Danbury Hattricks. Pump iron or tone up. Join Set Fitness and be the best you.
Mitchell, experience the difference. Mitchell has served the community since 1945. Heating oil, propane, and service for your home or business. Mitchell is ready to serve.
Oak Ridge Waste and Recycling has the roots in the community for all of your needs. Residential and commercial, Oak Ridge is the official sanitation partner of the Danbury Hattricks.
Hat City Physical Therapy is Danbury, Connecticut's leading provider of physical therapy and orthopedic specialists. Their highly skilled and caring team of licensed therapy providers are focused and committed to restoring your health and well-being so that you can return to the life you enjoy.
The inflatable guitars are on the ice. Some media timeout entertainment with 4:54 the reading on the second period clock. 2-0 Rockers and an offensive zone faceoff for the Hattricks. And Pat, we were just discussing the last two shifts from the Hattricks trending in the right direction, led by Johnny Ruiz.
Correct. And again, Babin's a pretty top goalie in this league. Again, having some ECHL experience this year with Kalamazoo Wings. It's definitely going to be tough to get a few things by him.
Now they've beaten him at the top of the net. They did it a couple times yesterday, picking a spot and hitting it. Obviously easier said than done. A scrum, net side. Berry wheels it. Brown pinching, shovels it below the goal line. Brown finishing his check in the corner on Smith. Rockers on the offense. Svitznov, pass across, shot stopped by McCollum. Extending and denying Miguel Diaz. The defenseman was in deep. Here's a nifty move, throw towards the middle by Smith, out to the point. It bounces over the blade of Colton. Whack back in with 4 minutes to go, middle period. Yao. Tape to tape with Harwell. Steps inside. Wrist shot. Engulfed by Babin. And the stoppage.
And again, that was a nice play there. It was really nice to see them just go tape to tape like that. Something we didn't see much of in the first period. So really, we're in the upward trend.
Matter of crispness. Not much of the tape-to-tape in period one. A little bit more here in the second. And as a result, you see cleaner entries into the zone and more scoring opportunities. Like Pat, would you rather bite into a mushy apple or a nice crunchy crisp one?
A big crispy apple guy. And
exactly.
Also got to say for bacon as well, big
exactly.
Crispy guy.
Exactly. No one wants a fatty piece of bacon.
Correct.
I like it well done.
Absolutely.
And the Hattricks want to be crispy in this one, and then they've drawn a penalty. Delayed call. Abdella at the left point shoots, deflected on goal, stopped by Babin with the pad. And after the whistle, Pamelain and Babin tied up. Babin wrestling Pamelain on the ground. The Rockers goaltender has already taken a penalty in this game. His mask is off. Pamelain is on top of him. They're barking at each other. The referee's trying to separate. Now Danbury is set to go on the power play with the assumption that there will be no additional penalties. Now Babin made a difficult stop on a deflection. And I believe they're getting Pamelain as well. Now Colton took the initial penalty. Patricks were swarming around Babin. Shot was deflected. Pamelain went head over heels onto Babin. That will most likely be a goaltender interference call and even things up.
These are things I really don't like to see from this Patricks team. Again, unnecessary penalties. We're just about to be on a power play for us. However, emotions got the best of Zach Pamelain, and now he's in the box as well, and it's most likely going to be another round of four-on-four hockey once everything is sorted out here in the Big Boy Arena.
Johnny Ruiz shaking his head. Can't believe it. It's four-on-four. So we're back to four-on-four hockey. Now Colton's being ushered off the ice. That's significant. We are awaiting the full calls. So Pamelain, goaltender interference. That the reason why he sits in the box. It's four on four hockey. Colton got 2 minutes as well, which I believe was the initial penalty, and then he was sent to the box, to the locker room rather. Vanderweel shot went wide, gets it back left circle. Thrown on goal, and McCollum holds it. All right, the penalties have come in. It's Pamelain for goaltender interference. At 16:41, Josh Colton cross-checking the initial penalty. That's served by Declan Conway because Colton was assessed a misconduct for abuse of officials. 10 minutes, he is gone from this game. Significant loss on the back end, offensively speaking. Yes, strong on the defensive end, but he's been a point-producing machine for Motor City in this series. Win at the left point, wrist shot, skitters on, right pad saved by McCollum. Gonzalez had his stick lifted, then he was hauled down. And Johnson galloping through center, charging ahead. Turnover, Abdellah stood up at the blue line, moves it forward. Johnson, center shot, wide by Gonzalez. Abdellah took a hit to make a play, and it almost resulted in the Hatricks finding the scoreboard. Harwell through center ice. Johnson, wrist shot, fluttered on, and a glove save by Babin as it changed direction at the last minute.
Quite an interesting one there, Doug, as he took that hit just to really get us with a scoring opportunity, which was probably one of the best things he could have done as a defenseman and as a teammate.
Milam off the faceoff, slips it across. 2 minutes remaining in the period. King gave it away near the blue line. Hat tricks from right to left. Berry, one-on-one with King, stole the puck. Starts the break the other way. Sneath, one on two into the zone. Swoops wide, backhander just
past the glove of McCollum. Point shot, Milam pinballs around in front. LaBelle chugs the other way. His wrist shot deflected. Patrick's, I believe it's delayed offsides. Thought LaBelle had the puck in the offensive zone and then shot it, but either way, they didn't blow it dead. It was a delay, and we play on. Still 4-on-4 for the next 2 seconds. Vanderwill shoots. It was Svitznov, rather, 29, who unloaded one over the net. Back to 5-on-5. Svitznov probing. Bedard on his hip. Svitznov dropping off. Koash turns, shoots into the mitt of McCollum. Approaching the final minute of the second period. Hat-tricks have yet to break through.
Again, I did kind of question that first one. Again, thought he was onside, but again, we did not recognize the late offsides at first. However, we still press on. Again, McCollum holding his ground.
No
so
harm,
far.
No foul, Pat.
Correct.
This off at the near circle. One back by the Hat-tricks and Gonzalez. Drew Johnson to DiNicola, bounces to Harwell right side. Giuliano swats at it. And numbers for the Rockers. Koash to Delaney. Back to Koash. He scores. Give and go. Second goal of the night for Scott Koash. We were wondering when he would introduce himself in this series. Tonight, the night, Rockers 3, Hat-tricks nothing. Koash to Delaney, back to Koash, one-timer, and the deficit grows to 3. Largest lead of the series for any team. And it happens with under a minute to go in game 3, period 2. Vanderwill charging right in front of the Rockers bench. He and Yao exchanging pleasantries. Ratcliffe, pocket picked by Conway. Final 20 seconds in the period. Vanderwill through Sneath all the way down. Race for it and an icing. Top goal scorer in the regular season. Now has 2 in this series. 1 on the power play and 1 at even strength. Ozone faceoff. LaBelle, wrist shot, gets through and Babin sweeps it aside. Woolley with 5. Fighting through, draws a penalty. Woolley to the back, it's touched up. And the Hat-tricks head to the power play, which will most likely carry over into the third.
Again, a good opportunity and hoping to capitalize on it here as the Hat-tricks desperately need it after that goal from Koash.
Hook on Mike Wynn. McCollum is to the bench with just 1.2. They need a face-off win and a quick shot. The goal, Koash from Delaney and Giuliano at 19-14 as the Rockers up by 3. Ruiz for the faceoff. LaBelle right behind him. Ruiz shoots off the draw, and it hits Sneath up high. It pinballed right into his face off the draw as Ruiz went forward. Ruiz going to check on Sneath. He appears to be okay. Both teams to the locker room. And the Hat-tricks 20 minutes away from their season coming to a close. One goal in the period. It was Koash in the final minute. A give and go with Delaney. And a 3-0 Motor City lead after 40 minutes of play. The few fans that are here at Big Boy Arena are on their feet cheering for the Rockers as they exit the ice. The hat tricks in both games, 1 and 2, held a 1-goal lead going into the third. Tonight, quite the opposite. They need 3 goals to tie and 4 to go in front. That's not an easy task in 20 minutes when a team knows that holding on to a lead results in a second round berth.
Yeah, and again, it's Detroit has not shown any signs of giving up. Again, the Rockers have come out of this game guns blazing, so to speak, and the hat tricks have just not been able to solve Babin, which is unfortunate for our case. However, I'm confident that we can put something together in this third period. I mean, the Rabbits are full of surprises, right? In that top hat, you never know what could come out of it.
So the hat tricks need a little bit of magic in the third period.
Yes, sir.
To come away with a win and meet up with Binghamton in the second round. So, the Rockers probably just played their two best periods of the postseason when it mattered most. And they have a 3-goal advantage heading into the third period. So, we'll have the third period for you. I'd say head to the kitchen, make yourself a sandwich. It's right about dinner time now, approaching 7 o'clock Eastern time.
Make a nice meal for yourself.
Heat something up, order in, whatever you like. Maybe TK's American Cafe.
Oh,
that's pretty good.
PB&J wings.
I have heard those are tasty. Probably not my cup of tea, but
personal favorite for me, Doug. I stand by those wings through in and throughout. It's delicious. That peanut butter kind of melts over the wings. You have the jelly with giving that sweetness to the salty, and they give you a nice side of fluff to dip the chicken with.
You're an absolute freak.
Listen.
Come on.
I heard a wise man once say, don't yuck somebody's yum.
Yes.
So,
oh, look what I've taught you this year.
Yes.
Look at that.
So I'm going to, again, I will stand on PB&J being the top wing out of the 76 flavors at Tiki's
wow.
American Cafe.
How many of the 76 have you tried? And there might be even more because the hat tricks wing is not on the menu.
Well, that is true. The secret menu wing making it a total 77 flavors. I have to say, probably around 7. So I may not be the most qualified person to say
goodness.
That the best.
Look at this guy.
But again, it's there's something about sweet and savory that just gets me going, Doug. It's, again, that peanut sauce, it works. You've seen it in other cultures of food. I've seen it in Thai food. They had the peanut sauce on the noodles. It tastes delicious, even on the chicken as well. I mean, it's just bound to work. I think that people are just afraid to go into a place where chicken and lunchtime should not meet, but it tastes so good.
Well, you say it's a magical combination. The hat trick's looking for a magical comeback in a must-win game 3 to advance to the second round of the 2024 Commissioner's Cup playoffs. Now, NHL playoffs started yesterday, and the local teams to Danbury, the Islanders and the Rangers, both in first-round matchups. The Rangers, the President's Cup Trophy winners, took care of business against Washington earlier today, 4-1. Matt Rempe had the spotlight on him. He delivered the game's opening goal. As for the Islanders, a hard-fought loss to the Hurricanes on the road last night. So two ends of the spectrum in terms of wins and losses for those squads in the NHL. The hat tricks, won game two, and a big question mark over game 3. And right now the seesaw is leaning in the direction of Motor City as the Rockers hold a 3-0 lead at the second intermission. All right, they're picking up the foam pucks off of the ice. It's chuck-a-puck time
in Big Boy Arena. That means we're going to step aside. Can the hat trick stage a comeback? Well, in about 13 and a half minutes, we will find out. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Danbury Hat Tricks Playoff Hockey on the Hat Tricks Digital Network.
Dental Care has served as the leader and preferred provider of dental care in Bethel, Connecticut. Go see Dr. K. He'll make you look like $1 million and feel like it too. The official team dentist of the Danbury Hat Tricks.
Vision Designs is the official merchandiser of the Danbury Hat Tricks. Vision Designs is a full-service screen printing, embroidery, signage, and promotional company locally owned and operated in Brookfield. Vision Designs is the hometown company with the national power. Check them out at visiondesignct.com.
Decker Tool Rental is the official full-service equipment rental shop of the Danbury Hat Tricks, providing a complete line of quality equipment to all types of contractors, tradesmen, and do-it-yourselfers. Visit them today at 84 Federal Road in Danbury or on the web at deckertoolrental.com.
Kafala Coffee. Real coffee, good coffee, no, great coffee. Plus hot chocolate right on the concourse level at the Danbury Ice Arena. Kafala Coffee. Stay warm this winter.
Clancy Moving and Relocation. Moving is stressful, but it doesn't have to be. Call Clancy and let them do the heavy lifting for you. Resident and commercial services plus other services such as storage. Remember, Clancy is fancy.
Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury is the premier automobile partner in the Danbury area. Located on Newtown Road, the Bennett family has been putting the community behind the wheel for over 35 years. Dream big, drive a Maserati or Alfa Romeo. New and pre-owned vehicles available. Let Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury be your choice.
Dowler Garage in New Preston specializes in batteries, brakes, and general service. When you're stuck, you're in luck. Call Mike so you don't need a bike. Dowler Garage.
Peach Wave of Bethel. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your place to go for a quality treat. Frozen yogurt and toppings, it doesn't get much better. Catch a wave, a peach one.
Reverie Brewing Company is a featured beverage in the Danbury Ice Arena. Grab a Reverie and don't quit your daydream. When you drink Reverie, anything is possible.
Set Fitness is the official gym and training center of the Danbury Hat Tricks. Pump iron or tone up. Join Set Fitness and be the best you.
Mitchell, experience the difference. Mitchell has served the community since 1945. Heating oil, propane, and service for your home or business. Mitchell is ready to serve.
Oak Ridge Waste and Recycling has the roots in the community for all of your needs. Residential and commercial, Oak Ridge is the official sanitation partner of the Danbury Hat Tricks.
Hat City Physical Therapy is Danbury, Connecticut's leading provider of physical therapy and orthopedic specialists. Their highly skilled and caring team of licensed therapy providers are focused and committed to restoring your health and well-being so that you can return to the life you enjoy.
Thank you.
Does Danbury have a trick up its sleeve? 20 minutes to find out as the Hattricks trail the Rockers 3-0 in the final game of the opening series of the 2024 Commissioner's Cup playoffs. We welcome you back inside Big Boy Arena with Patrick Frenette. I am Doug Latuca. First 40 minutes, all Rockers, as they have played two of their best periods of the playoffs. Hattricks with little to no answers. And it's been the Trevor Babin show when the Hattricks have had any opportunities within 10 feet of them.
It's been quite insane, to say the least. I mean, in the second period, they became a little more alive, getting more shots on net. But again, Babin is just really on it tonight. He wants this win probably more than anybody in this building. However, I know the Hattricks want it more and hoping for a nice three-goal comeback, maybe force an overtime and have a repeat of Friday, but in our favor.
Coash with two goals in the game, one on the power play, one even strength. TJ Delaney with two assists. The other goal scorer, Mike Wynn. So the Rockers with a shorty, a power play strike, and one even strength has them in the lead 3-0. And the Hattricks started to find their groove in that second period, Pat, but Coash took all the momentum back. A 2-on-1 with Delaney. Tape-to-tape passing. And Coash snapped it past the glove of McCollum, just like he did on the power play in the first period.
Correct, and that's one thing that we really got to be careful about in this final period if we want to really get back into the game, is penalties. Because there have been some really unnecessary penalties that we have taken, like the one that Pamela Leon took in the final seconds of the previous period. I mean, well, not even the final seconds, but the one where he was just on top of Babin, that did not need to happen. We're about to head to a power play, completely ditched the whole thing, turned into a 4-on-4. So really, you can play a clean game, not let the emotions get the best of us. Play strong 20 minutes of Hattricks hockey.
Well, the intermission clock has gone off, and now the Hattricks are on the ice. They beat the officials on the ice. Where are the stripes?
Kind of need those to start the game, though.
I guess they didn't get the memo. Oh, there they come out in the locker room.
They're back.
Wonder maybe they're taking a nap. You know, it is 3 games in 3 days. So the Hattricks come, then the refs, and then the Rockers. And Pat, don't worry, we will play period three, and the Hattricks have an opportunity to claw all the way back. Would be one of their more impressive wins of the season. They've come back from two down multiple times throughout the year. The one coming to mind most notably was in Binghamton, down two. It's happened twice. The Hattricks down two. Well, under 5 minutes to play. And they scored, tying it up, taking the lead. One they won in regulation, another they won in a shootout. And it starts with a quick start for Danbury. They're still on the power play for another minute and 59 seconds. Mike Wynn called for hooking at 19:59 of the second period as the Hattricks on a 5-on-4 for the opening 2 minutes or so. Teams flip sides. Hattricks from left to right need 3 to tie to keep their season alive. LaBelle runs this power play unit, turned over by King. The Hattricks forced to go 200 feet. Tapped on McKittrick, slipped for Johnson, and Milam snaps it back in deep. You'd have to anticipate Motor City. The focus on the defensive end, clearing pucks and limiting mistakes. Hattricks, desperation mode. Danbury with a minute 20 to work with on the power play. LaBelle at the blue line, wrist shot, deflected, spits out for Delaney, who clears. Winner of this game faces Binghamton in game one of the second round on Friday. Milam races after the puck. Shot it into Woolley, who keeps it in. Milam took it back and slings it the length. Ratcliffe, Woolley, and Yao in the hat-trick zone. Cunningham and Berry with them on the ice. Ratcliffe lost the handle. King trying to get around Yao. He does. King shorthanded. Shoots! Stopped by McCollum. The net comes off. Stoppage. And face off in the hat-trick zone with 26 seconds on the power play. Motor City with one shorthanded goal in this game, happened back in the first period. Almost had their second, but McCollum standing tall. Puck trickles into the hat-trick's netminder. Gets a stoppage. Face off at the near circle. Giuliano back forward to Laney. This shorthanded for Motor City. Giuliano. Gave it away. Berry. Back for Yao. Through center, Ratcliffe. Dumps off for Cunningham. Lofts it below the goal line. Hattrick's power play is over. Wynn is out of the box. Gonzalez swerving in Hattrick's territory. The lead for Johnson. Ahead for Gonzalez. Cuts inside. Late whistle, but an offside.
And an unfortunate power play for the Hattricks there as they were unable to convert. However, again, still 17:42 left to play in this period. I don't think the panic button should really be pressed yet. However, we do need to get more in the Rockets' defensive zone.
Not the start we both thought we'd see from the Hattricks. 2 minutes of power play time. And no shots. Actually, Motor City with a shot. Gonzalez around, picked off by Goulot. Harwell and Svintsov crashing. DiNicola on the blade of Harwell. Wrist shot, pad save. Babin kicks it out near the blue line. Rockers the other way. Goulot wrists one off the right pillow of McCollum. Chop to the left point, Win. Lost it to Johnson, throws it to the middle. DiNicola shouldered by Win at center. And a whistle, and a penalty right in front of the Rockers' bench. Interference, and it is on Mike Wynn. So Colton is still in the box. He had that abusive official. So he is still sitting in the Rockers' penalty box. Wynn joins them, interference, and the Hattricks another opportunity to cut into this Rockers lead on the power play. They have yet to score on the man advantage this series. Woolley leaping, couldn't keep. Ratcliffe spinning, and Yao will reset. Knifing through center, through Cunningham all the way down. Miguel Diaz shoved by Yao. It springs to the far corner, pressed ahead. Two on one for the Rockers, shorthanded. Delaney, right side for Giuliano. He hit the crossbar! Cunningham the other way. Left side, left the puck. And it is cleared. McCullum sprawling out. Might have got a piece. It looked like it went right off the iron clean from Giuliano. Either way, still 3-0 with a minute remaining on the power play. McKittrick with some room, shoots, blocked, rebound, thrown towards the goal and wide, past the lunging Ruiz. It's rainbow down the ice by the Rockers. We've played 4:30 in the third, 3-0 Motor City. They scored two in the first, one in the second, 40 ticks on the power play. McKittrick to the back, LaBelle, Ruiz. Feathers at McKittrick, sharp angle shot, chested down. Harwell shoots, blocked, and the Rockers sail it down the ice. Ruiz for Harwell. He's in. Harwell shoots off the blocker of Babin. That's the best chance for the hat tricks tonight. Johnson centers, stolen by Koash, can't clear. Brown steps, shoots, save! And Babin's got it covered. Once again, he looked back. Didn't know he had it. But it's that type of night for Trevor Babin. 4 seconds remaining on the win penalty. A face-off in the Rocker zone when we come back on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Hope Plumbing offers a full range of commercial and residential services. Their team can assist you in all aspects of any plumbing-related needs you have. You have hope with Hope Plumbing.
Kellogg Hardwood Lumber, located in Bethel, has the hardwoods for any project. They are a kiln-dried hardwood lumber yard and manufacturing facility carrying the highest quality hardwoods available. Flooring, moldings, cabinets, furniture, or whatever you are building, they have the kiln-dried hardwoods you need.
Since 1881, Omaha Beef Company has been supplying the Danbury community with meat and beef. Located on Maple Avenue, they are now the featured product in the Danbury Ice Arena. When you say Omaha Beef Company, you mean top of the line.
Bold Move Logistics is a family-owned and operated delivery service provider exclusively for Amazon. As a team, they deliver packages the last mile to your doorstep. Check them out on the concourse level at the Danbury Arena and inquire about joining their team.
Ozone faceoff, final 4 seconds of the Hattricks power play. We're 5-10 into the third, and Danbury in a 3-goal hole. Winner of this one heads to the second round. Faceoff at the right circle, Sneath and Harwell. Rockers possess, King clears, and out of the box is Wynn. Conway lost an edge, went crashing into the boards. He's back to his skates. Brown, D to D, Yao. Takes one goal for the Hattricks to get back in it. We've seen this team score in bunches all year. McCullum out of the goal, steered it near side, gave it away. Sneath dropping off for King. King dancing near the blue line, tape to tape. Smith to the right point, Wynn. Angle down low, Smith. Has some room. Pass down low, shot Spitznov, stumped by McCullum and covered. Spitznov on the doorstep. Not much of an angle. McCullum does his job. Keeps it a 3-goal deficit.
All we really need to do this period, Doug, we got to get in our offensive groove. Again, the defense has been doing somewhat of a job at really holding it down, but again, offense is key in this final period.
Rockers win another faceoff. Ruiz pries it free. Locates Gonzalez up ahead for Woolley. Into the zone, Woolley shoots. Sticked aside by Babin. And the Rockers chip it out to center. Ruiz dives, gets it to Gonzalez, and Woolley spinning, nearly turned it over. But Ruiz, the lumberjack it down, and an icing. Seen a frustrated group of Hattricks tonight, Pat, but not a nervous-looking one or a desperate squad. And once this clock peels under 10 minutes, I'd assume we'll see a little bit more desperation.
Absolutely.
Season on the line.
Abdella clanks it off the glass. Thrown ahead over the stick of Koash. Possession back to Motor City. Miguel Diaz out to neutral ice. Couple players over skate. Giuliano touched for Delaney, 2-on-1. Delaney drag, shoots, blocked by Abdella into the netting. And that at the end of a long shift for Abdella. Good play, getting his stick in the lane.
And again, this is a team that knows how to keep a poker face on. And obviously they've kept it through two full periods of play and almost 7 minutes in this period. But again, under 10 minutes and that poker face might slowly fade.
Gulo and Berry at the far circle, Patrick's D zone. Rockers win it, flub towards the slot. Back to the blue line and McKittrick pushes for LaBelle into the zone, trickles into the near corner. Milam gets a pass from Miguel Diaz. In stride, Smith cuts inside, charging to the goal, ran into McCollum, who made the save, and the net comes off.
McCollum looked a little shaken up on that, but I think he's okay. Skating back to the crease now. Kind of shaking his leg a little bit. Might have got hit by a body or two on that one, but nonetheless, we push on.
McCollum has been superb tonight. Trevor Babin has just been a bit better. 24 shots for the Rockers, 22 for the Hattricks, and three nearly impossible shots to save have resulted in three goals for Motor City. On the faceoff, Johnson and Conway swinging sticks at each other. Well, that would be an unfair fight. Johnson, shoved by Sneed, shrugs it off, motors forward. At the blue line, Yao, shot blocked. Harwell wheels it around. Brown pinching. King around the kick plate, Yao keeps to the net, deflected wide. King to the far side, Johnson finishing his check. Headband pass too far, it's an icing.
Bit of some color commentary down the ice, some might call it, but.
We need a bleep button.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, it was Johnson's game last night. He had the two goals, including the game winner. Tonight he's been noticeable. Hattricks have yet to score, and the Rockers trying to get under his skin. Yao snaps it into the Motor City zone. Under 12 to go in the third period. Hattrick season on the line. McKittrick forced the turnover, centered off the stick of Berry, and back out to center ice. Hamelain paired with Abdella, with the Hattricks looking for any type of offense. McKittrick slips it ahead for Ratcliffe, turned aside at the blue line. Giuliano had his stick lifted by McKittrick, and it shoveled in by Ratcliffe. Hattricks make partial changes. Harwell right back on the ice. Double was out there with Ruiz and Johnson about a minute ago. Errant pass. Milam scoops it in deep. Delaney tangled with Abdella. Koash to the back. Milam wrist shot. Waffle save. Woolley gets out of danger. Steps inside the line, double teamed. Keeps it moving forward around for Harwell. Presses it back to Woolley, far corner. Left point, LaBelle. Quickly across, Bedard. Wrist shot. Pippen saw it the whole way. And he covers. And now shoving after the whistle. And Ruff's going over the top of DiNicola, who was laying on the ice. DiNicola was hurt on the ice. And the scrum toppled over him.
You never know what's going to happen in this league, Doug, and that's just one of the few things that I quite have honestly never seen before. Never really seen it get to that point. Sure, I've seen refs fall with players, but I've never seen them fall over another player. Obviously, we hope DiNicola's okay as he... slow to get back up to his skates. He's skate off.
He was shaken up prior to the incident. Time bleeding off the clock, Pat, and the Hatricks need 3 goals in under 11 minutes to stay alive in 2024.
Obviously, that's what I imagine all the fans want back home, and we're hoping so here at the Big Boy Arena as well.
It's pretty much been one goal games all series. Tight down to the wire today, a different story. Here's Johnson, shoots, saved by Babin. He tucked it underneath his left arm. There's that sneaky wrister of Johnson. He only needs an ounce of space. He'll get it off. But Babin making the saves that he has to. No screen in front. That's Johnson on Babin. Shooter on goalie. And Babin stays perfect. Far circle draw. 24 saves for Babin. LaBelle wrister. Tipped wide by Johnson, who retrieves in his skates, flings one towards goal off of Harwell. Lead for Koash. Bedard is back. Koash has 2 tonight. Delaney had it taken away. Koash at the ring of the right circle. Snapped one over the net. Giuliano out of play, and Johnson dumps him in front of the Hatricks bench.
Again, some nice physical play from Johnson. Always something that's a pleasure to see. And really, he's kind of a double-edged sword. He's got that physicality on him, and he's got that wrister that can be pretty violent in some situations, especially like yesterday.
Hatricks searching for answers. One goal can get the party started. They just need to beat Babin once. They have yet to do so. For the first 50 minutes. We've hit the midway point, third period. McGill Diaz run into by Harwell. And the Rockers lift out to center. King tosses in. McCollum out of the net. Plays near side, Ratcliffe. Spins out of trouble. Cross ice, Yao gets the red line. Chases after it. McGill Diaz. Give it away, Ratcliffe near side. Thrown towards the goal, deflects to the far side. Yao shoots, blocked down. Ratcliffe keeps it towards the net. Wide, Harwell, fan on the shot, inside for LaBelle, through the slot, and Conway will reorganize. And a penalty. Both will go, McGill Diaz and Harwell. And we're back to 4-on-4, Pat.
Back to 4-on-4, and... again, not situations that we want to be in. These unnecessary penalties, I don't know why they keep happening. But again, it's emotions, right? So it's emotions getting the best of these players and could cost us in the end.
Frustration certainly creeping in for the Hatricks. Down 3-0 with under 10 minutes to go. Media timeout here in Fraser, Michigan. We'll step aside on the Hatricks Digital Network.
Charter Oak Brewing Company is a Connecticut-based brewery featuring handcrafted and innovative beers such as pale ales, lagers, India pale ales, brown ales, sours, and several seasonal, more robust beers. Pick one up at the Rabbit Hole.
Danbury Pace, Chipman, Mizuko, and Emerson is your partner for the road ahead. They provide comprehensive legal guidance for individuals, families, and businesses. CME, let the pros handle your needs.
Domino's, the official pizza of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Thin crust, pepperoni, sausage, you name the topping, and they got it. Domino's, they deliver.
Partner with Fastenal to simplify and secure your supply chain needs. They handle a vast range of industrial products, and if you want it, they can get it. The core belief is in the people at Fastenal. They empower their teams to do great things for yours.
Grounds Donut House is the featured donut of the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by the main stand and grab yourself one of today's featured donuts. As good as it gets, donut, miss out.
Do you like your grass green or do you want weeds? Yard Goats Landscaping and Construction services Fairfield and Litchfield County. Their specialties are tree service, excavation, patios, decks, and making your grass green. Check out yardgoats.io and get green with the team. Back inside Big Boy Arena in Fraser, Michigan. Time is ticking on the Hat-Tricks. They need 3 goals in 9 minutes and 20 seconds to keep their season alive. Winner of this one plays Binghamton Friday night in the second round opener. 4-on-4 hockey. McGill, Diaz, and Harwell are in the box for the next 2 minutes. Embellishment on McGill, Diaz, cross-checking on Harwell. Good opportunity for LaBelle. Follow-up was covered by Babin. One of the best chances we've seen for the Hat-Tricks. LaBelle on the far side and off the left pad of Babin.
And again, it's, I really just can't stress enough just how good Babin is to this Rockers team. And how the Hat-Tricks really just need to dial in and really take every shot that they can take off. Because again, 8:47 left to play here in 4-on-4. And not the best scenario to be in, but I've seen some crazy stuff in this league and not ruling out a comeback.
Just saw the replay on that LaBelle shot. He was looking for a rebound and it took an awkward hop off the pad and Ruiz couldn't reach it. Gonzalez shoot save, rebound, Berry swinging a miss. Spits to the near side, up top Abdella for Ratcliffe, walks in, Ratcliffe shoots, blocked. Vanderwill gets there first and out to center. Gonzalez in front, knocked away. Now, Motor City has just 4 players on the ice. Hat-Tricks have 5. It must be a power play, but there's only 2 penalties on the board. Abdella, low left, return. Abdella shoots it wide. Ratcliffe races over to keep it in. Abdella shoots, deflected, chopped wide. Ratcliffe gets to it, under 8 to play. Cross slot through Abdella. Fending off a check, and Sneed fires it down.
We actually took McCollum out of the net there to get that extra attacker.
Thank
on.
Thank you, Pat. I apologize.
No, it's all good.
I was not anticipating that with more than 8 minutes to go in the third period. When you are down 3, desperate times call for desperate measures. So it was coinciding minors on McGill, Diaz, and Harwell. Embellishment and cross-checking respectively, and the Hat-Tricks did empty the net, causing a 5-on-4 for the Hat-Tricks, and Danbury has taken its timeout.
And again, like you said, desperate times, desperate measures. It's really all down to this. If we go and play against the top-seeded Black Bears this Friday night, which everyone I would assume on this broadcast, at least from the fan perspective, is hoping for. And it's, again, it's going to be a rough 7 minutes and 44 seconds to hopefully get on the board. Some great opportunities we had back there. Again, just people that weren't quite in position yet. were unfortunately not able to get some setup because the back door was wide open at least twice there and just couldn't connect.
You can feel the desperation from the hat tricks now, but Pat, you almost wish it was there at the puck drop. It's been Motor City's night. They've controlled the pace. Hat tricks need 3 goals in under 8 minutes. The net is empty. Yeah, cross ice, McKittrick shoots, blocked. Ruiz to the net, the rebound stopped by Babin, sprawling save. LaBelle for Ruiz, oh what a save by Babin! Ridiculous! LaBelle shoots wide, off the end boards, McKittrick. That was insanity. Babin's got his stick back, now it's a 6-on-5, the net empty. In the slot, Harwell fan. Popped in the air, Yao. For LaBelle, slap shot. Pinball's around, it's available, and it's underneath Babin. Unreal.
Unreal.
Babin with the two best saves of the series to preserve the shutout and keep the 3-goal lead. The hat tricks can't do much more to create a grade A chance. Babin diving full extension kept the puck out of the net.
Quite insane, Doug. And again, you know, he lost his stick midway through that entire chaos, still held it down in the net. That last one, I definitely thought it was going to get that extra push to go behind the net, but he just laid right on top and kept the shutout going.
The net empty for the hat trick. 6 skaters for Danbury. Gonzalez across for Abdella. Berry, Woolley, Cunningham, and Johnson, the four forwards. Off the stick of Gonzalez, Johnson wins the battle and shovels it in deep. Rimmed around Abdella. Down low, centering pass, Cunningham. Touched by Berry, shoots, scores! And the hat tricks have some life. Billy Berry with a roof job. It's 3-1.
I could feel it, Doug. I felt that it was going to happen there. And lo and behold, it is 3-1. Shutout has been spoiled officially. And the hat tricks could really ride this for the next 6.5 minutes.
Under the bar, the spot to beat Babin. And the hat tricks finally get on the board with 6:32 remaining in the third period. And now a 2-goal deficit with just 6.5 seems a lot more doable for this hat trick squad.
And McCollum back in net for the hat tricks. Will be 5-on-5 here.
So the risk pays off for McCreary and company. Hattricks controlling the play as of late. They're on the board. Yao around the net. And the Rockers get it to center. Approaching 6 minutes to go. Yao, right wing. Lost the handle. Finds Harwell, back down low, McKittrick has space, pass in front, he had Ruiz peeking on the right side doorstep. Harwell turnaround shot snagged with the mitt by Babin, and no rebound. McKittrick nearly snapped his stick over his head as he knew he had a great opportunity. And Patty was in a perfect spot to do what Berry just did, which is in tight, over the shoulder of Babin and under the bar. As we've said multiple times, it's easier said than done. But the hat tricks bench on their feet. They have some juice. They got a goal on this shift. This game will be flipped on its head. Vanderwill in the D zone. Delaney for the empty net, wide, and an icing. So McCreary pulling McCollum, extra skater on. Hat tricks have used their timeout. Rockers still have theirs.
Six skaters are Ratcliffe, Barry DiNicola, Johnson, Abdellah, and Gonzalez. Right circle draw. Two-goal lead for the Rockers, but the hat tricks with the most recent score. Barry from Cunningham and Woolley at 13-28. The empty net on the hat trick side. Barry retrieves behind the net. Took a stick up high. Clutching at his face, nothing called. Sail down, trickling wide of the empty net, and an icing.
Some risky stuff here, Doug. Kind of reminds me of how Tortorella kind of coaches his team in the Flyers. Again, making some insane risks, but again, the greater the risk, the higher the reward, might say.
Minnesota Wild pulled their goalie.
Yes,
in a tie overtime. Game, yes. In overtime. And ended up winning. It paid off. Babin covers. Cunningham hauled down by Wynn after the whistle. And the faceoff right back at the near circle. Doug Lotuka with Patrick Frenette. Final game of the opening round. Winner plays Binghamton next Friday night in the Empire Division Finals. Patrick's trailed 3-0. They got on the board at 3:28 of this period, looking for more. LaBelle back for Woolley, right circle. Return LaBelle right point. Shot deflected wide to the far corner. Delaney chops at it. Cunningham keeps it at the line across LaBelle. Walk shoots high and into the netting. Final media timeout of regulation. Rockers 3, Hattricks 1. Danbury playing with desperation. They have some juice. Can they complete the comeback? The final 5 minutes when we return on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Tixer is the official ticketing partner of the Danbury Hattricks and Danbury Ice Arena. Log on and get your seats today. Great service and easy to use.
Tri-State Legacy Group is an insurance group that focuses on putting your family needs first. Consult with them today and set your plan for the future. They care about people over products. It's that simple.
Twister's Ice Cream Cafe. Located in New Fairfield, Twister's features 32 different flavors of ice cream. This season, they are stationed in the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by and visit their stand. Get sprinkled.
New Haven Nighthawk Brewing. Brewed right here in Connecticut and featured at the Rabbit Hole. New Haven Night Brewing Company is the beverage of choice at the Danbury Arena. Grab a cold one and party like you're in the Elm City.
The frantic Final Five. Inside Big Boy Arena, Fraser, Michigan. Winner advances, loser goes home, and the season comes to an end. Ozone faceoff, the net is empty. 6-on-5 for the Hattricks. Sneathan Ruiz. Motor City wins it. Available puck. Swept all the way down. It's an icing on Motor City. Oh no! They waved off the icing. So we play on. Woolley at center. Gets some room. Shoots. Glove save. Babin.
Definitely a little perplexed by the no icing. However, we still end up being where we want to be in the Rockers' defensive zone. So hopefully we can still take advantage of that.
And it seems like time is starting to slow a little bit.
Yes.
And the hat trick's getting on the board with about 7.5, 8 minutes on the clock. Now 4:31 to work with. Need two goals to force overtime. Abdellah closing off Conway. Beat him to the puck. Empty net for Danbury. Six skaters. Ruiz with Woolley, Harwell, Cunningham, LaBelle, and Yao. Cunningham shoots. Gathered in by Babin. Hattricks do not have their timeout. They used it and scored with the net empty.
They need three empty net goals to tie this game, Pat. They got one.
Again, easier said than done, Doug. It's going to be a hard-fought battle till the end.
Johnson shoots right into the breadbasket of Babin. Mid-slot Johnson. And Babin on top of his crease makes the save.
And for the viewers at home, just moments ago, went to my smartwatch to see my heart rate at the moment. Currently 114 BPM, so.
Is that bad?
Cardiac arrest might happen in the booth, God forbid, but we press on.
Off the face-off, off float down, doesn't have the legs. Ratcliffe with under four, 3-1 Rockers. Winner advances, turnover at center, back into the hat-trick zone, Yao. Ratcliffe navigating out to center. Into the zone, puts on the brakes, filters it around. Miguel Diaz had his stick lifted, Yao. Near side, McKittrick. Fanned on the pass, Giuliano. Backhand shovel, wobbling puck, and icing on Motor City.
And again, this really does feel like sands in an hourglass right now. Time just about half the speed you would think it would be. Full minute has gone by. It feels like an hour to me, Doug.
3:20, two goals. Hat-tricks win the draw. LaBelle shoots, deflected on goal, and Babin steers it near side. Woolley to it first. Blocked, gets it back. Hamilton wrist shot, slithers through, deflected wide, kept in Woolley at the blue line. Left side, Ruiz shoots into the netting, might have been blocked, and another faceoff upcoming in the Rocker zone.
This really is one of the most exhilarating last 5 minutes I've seen in a game this year, Doug. It's going to be rough to see what happens going forward. And
well, it does appear that the Rockers took the timeout earlier, not the hat trick. So Danbury uses its timeout now. It's just sometimes a lack of communication on the ice causes some confusion up here, but timeout to timeout.
Correct. Again, it's time for the coaches to
it's
really
time for
just
a timeout.
Exactly, it's time for a timeout. No, but it's really for the hat tricks right now. It's really time for McCreary to just tell his team again, we're in do or die mode right now. Currently down by two goals. If we want to force an overtime, and we really just got to keep it pushing again. Remember, that net has no goaltender in it on the other end, so you better not let that puck escape into the neutral ice, and if you do, you better have the legs to go in front of it.
Hat-tricks out shooting the Rockers 39-25, but Motor City in the lead 3-1. Two goals in the first, one in the second for the Rockers. Hat-tricks with a lone score here in the third. 2:58 on the clock, and Danbury needs two. Left circle draw. Harwell kicks it back. Pamelaan nearly gave it away. Ruiz winds, fires! Deflected wide. Wynn can't clear. Ruiz gloves it down, throws it towards the goal off the stick of Babin. Harwell to the back, LaBelle. Takes the shot, toe drags. Backhander pops in the air. And LaBelle slaps it below the goal line. Harwell in front. Now behind the net. The shot stopped by Babin. Woolley went down. All the way for the empty net. It's wide. And an icing on the Rockers yet again.
Again, these risks seem to be paying off. It's just a matter of finding the right lane at the right time.
Six skaters on. Barry McKittrick, Cunningham, Johnson, Abdella, and Ratcliffe. Off the face-off, the Rockers clear. It is Yao, not Abdella. The lone defenseman on the ice for the hat-tricks. McKittrick ripped down. Motor City gets it out. 2 minute warning here in Michigan. 3-1 Rockers. Berry zigzags through center. Hands off for Johnson. Return for Berry. Shoots, save, rebound available. They whack away. It's underneath Babbitt and the whistle. Couple times Babin has went into sprawl mode and he's kept the puck out all during those instances.
Again, just really shows the athleticism of Trevor Babin and the way he's able to just kind of keep that puck out. And again, using his full body to the max, really using every appendage like its own instrument.
Harwell and Sneath for the draw. Tie up and a clear from Motor City and an icing. Faceoff going back into the Motor City zone. Well, the Hattricks are putting on the pressure. This has been their best 8 to 10 minutes of the postseason thus far. Babbin with a couple highway robberies. Off the faceoff. Rockers out to center. Shot from Conway off the iron. And LaBelle. Under a minute and a half to go. LaBelle gets the red line. Snaps it around. Miguel Diaz chops. Lost the handle. LaBelle trying to pass across. There's Delaney with the net empty. Shoots. Scores. And that just about does it. Clock never started. So they will redrop at center most likely. They'll drop it at the near dot. Final 105 of the season. Puck on goal, McCollum will cover. And we're under a minute. Hattricks with a valiant effort in the back half of the third. And Motor City come away with this one, 4-1. Cunningham blocks a pass. 2-on-1, Cunningham in front. DiNicola lost the handle. DiNicola for Cunningham. Across one-timer stopped by Babin. Miguel Diaz in the corner, whistle blows. Yao was down on the ice, crashed into Babin. It's a cross check. That is Smith going to the box for cross checking. So a power play with 40 seconds left in a 4-1 game.
Not meant to be dropped yet. So
Yeah, 38 seconds remaining. Hattricks on the power play. Johnson shoots. Blocked. Ruiz. Rister. Another block. Free in the high slot. Chopped out to center ice. And
that
the
is
final
empty
25
once again.
Seconds. Empty net. So it's a 6-on-4. Johnson with Milam at the blue line, off camera,
He's grabbing at him, trying to drop the gloves. Miguel Diaz ripping him off. Brown ties him up.
And I'm assuming they'll take Johnson off the ice for the final 11 seconds here in the third.
Johnson to the locker room.
And that's pretty much the exclamation point as this series is about to end in Motor City's favor.
Truly one of the more chaotic games I've ever witnessed in my time with this organization, and I'm just currently speechless at the moment, Doug. I might take this next 11 and a half to really just kind of get my thoughts together here. However, let's watch these boys finish it strong. And again, you know, they put it all out there, even if it's for one last time this season.
Yeah, McCollum back in the net. 4-on-4 hockey for the last 11.5. The fans here at Big Boy Arena are on their feet. Puck is dropped. Yao with it for the hat tricks. Final 5 seconds. And the Motor City Rockers advance for the first time in franchise history. They top the hat tricks 4-1 in game 3 of the first round in the 2024 Commissioner's Cup playoffs. And the season comes to an end for the Danbury Hattricks. The defense of the cup ends in round 1. Lost a hard-fought round 1 game in Danbury in overtime. Prevailed in game 2 in another back-and-forth affair last night. And tonight, Motor City played its game. Scored a couple of goals on the special teams. Scott Koash was noticeable. Most impressive player for Motor City in game 3, and their top goal scorer in the regular season and point producer came through when it mattered most for a Rockers team that will soak in their first playoff series win in franchise history.
Correct, and again, Babin doing Trevor Babin things, and he becomes the better goaltender of the series between himself and Connor McCollum, and it's really been a treat to watch these two teams go at it. And again, a hard-fought season, and it's definitely not the way we thought tonight would go.
Yeah, well, we were spoiled this series with two of the top goaltenders in the league. Babin ends the night 42 for 43. McCollum allowed 3 goals with him in the net. One of the Motor City goals, an empty netter. So he stops 23 of 26 shots. Well, 22 of 25 that he faced, and then the one that went in, the empty netter. Hattricks fans sticking around, applauding Danbury's season. It was not smooth sailing. No. Last year was a coast through, best team in the league. Impressive in the playoffs. Backs were against the wall in the finals. They found ways to win in those final 3 games, including the overtime victory over Carolina. And this season, there were spurts of great play, But in this game three, the Rockers deserve some credit for limiting Danbury's opportunities. And then in the final 10 minutes of the third, Hattricks were in desperation mode, and Babin stole the show.
Absolutely, and again, Motor City giving their fans a great send-off here before.
That might be the loudest 500 people I've ever heard, Pat.
Absolutely, Doug. Again, an intimate arena here at Big Boy in Fraser, Michigan, and it's really a bittersweet night tonight. Players not wanting to exit off the ice just quite yet. But again, this Motor City team has shocked a lot of people on its way through its journey through its second year as a franchise.
And who knows the future of a guy like Johnny Ruiz, Dustin Henning, Steve Brown, some of the veterans on this Hattricks team who will have some questions to answer in the offseason if we will see them back in 2024-25. All right, so the Rockers take game three. They will play here at Big Boy Arena on Friday night versus the number two team in the league, the number one seed of the Empire Division, the Binghamton Black Bears, who just swept Watertown in their first round matchup. And that'll be round two. And then the Commissioner's Cup Finals in a couple weekends from now. That just about does it for us up here in the booth. A couple thank yous to hand out within the Hattricks organization. Want to start off with my interns who did a terrific job helping out, whether it was articles, social media, interviews. They were spectacular. Lexi Berkey, Jordan Simmons, Melanie Grasso, Bella Mishral, Sophia Tazi, Ryan. We haven't seen him in a while, but he was outstanding for us, helping us with the game notes. Then in the management, Herm Sorcher, president of the Hattricks, the ownership group. We appreciate your support. Nick Garofalo and Abby Greiner, general managers of the Danbury Ice Arena. Of course, Billy McCreary, head coach and general manager of the Hattricks, who does so much for the community and for the organization as a whole. Want to send a special shout out to Calvin Savoia. Presses all the right buttons upstairs, does the job of five people, and does it extremely well. Really helped us settle in at the beginning of the season in my first year with the team. And of course, the man to my left, Patrick Frenette. If Calvin's doing five jobs, this guy's doing six. And he put color on his resume this weekend here in round one, and you did a spectacular job. Really appreciate all of your help. Was a pleasure working with you this weekend.
Absolutely.
One of the OGs with the Danbury Hattricks. And you have a couple of words. You can go right ahead.
Yes, Doug. To start, thank you for, you know, letting me help out this weekend, hop on the broadcast with you. It's been something special, you know, being with the Hattricks for three seasons now. It's, you know, definitely a second family to me. I do want to send some thank yous out to our game day crew, like you mentioned before, Calvin Savoy, our broadcast director, and our pretty much Swiss Army knife of the group, Leo Vieira, who worked several cameras in the building, mainly was our chase cam operator, Andreas Klaub, our delightful public address announcer.
Outstanding.
And our penalty box operators, Tom and Connor. Again, and a big thank you to ownership, as well as Herm Sorcher and Nick Garofalo, for keeping me around for these three seasons and letting me be a part of something special with this group. And probably the biggest thank you will go to our fans. I mean, without them, there's none of this. There's none of Doug on play-by-play. There's an Amion color. There's an Amion camera. So, again, huge thank you to our fans. And I don't know if you have any other words to express, Doug.
A disappointing end to the 2023-24 campaign. But the Hattricks went down swinging. Played great in the final 10 minutes of that third period and came up just short. A couple final words from me. Graduated from Syracuse in May of 2023. Accepted the job here in Danbury in July. Season kicked off in October, and it has been quite the experience. One that you could write a book about, one that you'll remember forever. And it has been my honor and my pleasure to be the voice of the Danbury Hattricks this season and bring the game into your living room each and every game. So, one final time, the Rockers 4, the Hattricks 1. Motor City advances to the second round of the playoffs, their first series win in franchise history. And the Hattricks head to the offseason looking to retool and rebuild. Thank you to all the fans and all the men and women who have worked tirelessly this season to make the Danbury Hattricks organization and the product on the ice go. It has been a roller coaster, lots of ups and downs, and we appreciate you for sticking along for the ride. We'll head to the bus and back to Danbury.
Oh, love it. That's awesome. All right. See you guys every night.
As the fans continue to pile out of Big Boy Arena. For Patrick Fournette on my left, I'm Doug Letuca, saying have a great rest of your night, Hattricks fans. Enjoy the summer. And you know the Hattricks will be back in 2024-25. Thanks for a great season, fans, and we'll talk again soon.